It happened. You hear the liveness?
I hear us live.
I actually hear nothing.
Hmm. Well,
okay, we're not live
I'm
then.
Good.
I'm guessing we are live.
Yeah.
This is the part of the show where we embarrass ourselves by not knowing if we're live or not for the first 3 or 4 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
But welcome back to the groundbreaking, record-shaking, unbelievably done baking. Finale of our episode.
We're not done baking yet.
No, well, this is it. We're going to pull it out of the oven tonight.
Oh.
We've been baking it for 17 episodes or so. And now, we're going to beat it. We're going to conquer this game.
Yeah, that's pretty much what we're going to do.
I think we deserve it. I think we're good people who put in the hours. And we'll be the well-heralded champions of this world.
Just for beating this game? Yeah, there's a lot of doom. Oh, what is that?
Oh, it's a creepy dude. It's a worm. It's a worm dude.
Oh, no. Look at it.
Should we try to fight it?
In a sec. We need to get a good old Snoop Lion. We gotta get him. We'll battle. we're gonna take care of this real quick.
So we are going to the end of the game, the Northern Cavern.
Crater.
To fight Sephiroth for good, once and for all. But first, you spent some time off screen getting the mythical golden chocobo, right?
Yeah, if you want to spoil it, yeah, we did.
Oh, spoil it? It's happening now.
Bogenhagen seems rather down ever since he returned from that trip. I'm worried something might happen to Bogenhagen now, of all times. Ugh.
He's been missing.
Now, of all times.
We haven't seen him since we left him to die in that city of the ancients. Bryce just couldn't spend the time to help him out.
I'm not interested.
Now he's missing, Bryce.
He's not missing, he's just not feeling well, right?
Well, he wasn't here when we looked last time.
Okay. I think Bogenhagen has foreseen things about the planet, about Nanaki, you keep calling him Snoop Lion, and about himself. But Bogenhagen would never say that. He always says, ho ho ho!
That's true.
He does say that.
And Hojo says, hee hee.
Hee hee, no ho.
And Scarlet says, kaya. Oh, very unique laughs. That's how you just show characters. You spell laughing differently.
Yeah, definitely.
I thought Shakespeare did it.
Yeah.
Bryce, how was your Valentine's Day?
Especially Festus. Festus is his name? Oh, I don't know if that's right.
That's a wrestler. No, that's Festus.
That's also a Seinfeld holiday. Who's talking?
You.
No need to be sad. Even if something should happen, everything will return to the planet. Bogenhagen says so. Just the thought of something happening to Bogenhagen worries me.
According to my Gmail, you live.
I need to be wary of these because something just happened.
I'll let you listen.
Okay. Some lady said something. Read it for us.
No need to be sad. This is what I just read.
Am I even talking? That's that lady.
Yes.
I want to know what the kid says. Okay. What's wrong with Bogenhagen? Is he sick? He looks like death. Ugh. He makes me want to puke.
Hey, Bryce, Kevin wants to know how your Valentine's Day was.
Cassius Clay.
Our viewers out there.
Cassius Clay?
No, Kevin.
Ah, see, I heard it.
Oh, she was talking to you.
Yeah. Cassius Clay.
Oh, man. Everything will be over once the meteor hits. I've been selling materia for 10 years now, ever since I was dancing at 16. Jeez. What have I been doing with my life?
Oh, Mr. Kyle.
I just want... Oh, well, welcome. Oh, it's nothing. Now, please make yourself comfortable. We're gonna sleep?
We're gonna... We really need to buy anything here?
I think we should buy
everything. Well, we've got a good surplus of these. I'm going to buy an extra one of those. Why not?
Surplus, not a sur minus.
That's a gender exclusive term.
Surplus? Sir?
Yeah. Person plus.
Person plus. Human plus.
Stuff plus.
Cassius Clay. Hey, tell everybody about your freaking New Year. Or your Valentine's. The people are clamoring to know.
I worked!
Yeah!
I've already mentioned where I worked. I don't want to mention it again.
He worked hard. It's a busy day.
It's a gift place. A place where you can buy gifts for your loved one. And apparently people have loved ones.
Damn all this love!
Ugh. But I had to answer a lot of calls about people being upset. That's what those phone calls were all about. It's like, oh man, I didn't get my thing that I bought with my money. I want my money back. I'm like, yeah, alright.
Is this sarcasm? Brian says we have such nice portraits for our YouTube profile. Sounds like
Wait, is he talking about the post-it note?
I don't know. No, that would be the Facebook profile. We're so... it's such a poignant joke that we don't even know of what he refers to. What's your busiest day of the year? They want to know.
Mother's Day?
What you call me?
Mother's Day?
Your Mother Day.
Kevin and Sarah.
Mother's Day, people love their mothers even more than their other loved ones. We all know it.
I have no idea where Bugenhagen is.
Is it necessary we find him?
He's got Snoop Lion's ultimate weapon, I think.
Sounds convincing.
Yeah, I know. Is he on this area? No, it's not near the fire. Where is he?
Oh, he's talking to them. Oh, they do. They do have really nice portraits.
He's finally come home, but Bugenhagen doesn't seem well. Oh. Is he?
Thanks, Brain.
Still him.
You're welcome, Brain. I want to hear Bugenhagen talk with Inaki like we used to do. We used to do it that way.
We used to do it like that.
Yeah.
So we are going to get a few ultimate weapons. We're going to fight a few monsters. We're going to get a few secrets. And at about 6, we are going to walk into the mouth of the beast.
The mouth of the beast. If you want to look up where the hell Bugenhagen is.
No. Oh, you think I just ask Google where Bugenhagen is? It'll come straight up? Because that'd be cool.
It's not back there.
Where? Let's see what she says. Where?
Disc 3. Where's Bugenhagen?
Bugenhagen. I'm definitely going to spell that right.
Yeah. I just put FF7.
Where's Bugenhagen in Disc 3? Comes right up. All I have to put is where is Bug? Where can I find Bugenhagen for the limited moon?
What we want.
I want the unlimited moon.
Well, geez, don't you want everything?
I defeat a diamond weapon and want to get the thing. I'm in Cosmo Canyon and can't find him. That sounds familiar.
Do we have time?
The accepted answer was just he returns to Cosmo Canyon.
What?
In the observation tower. Did you climb way up where you can put the materia and stuff into the diorama? I guess it's called.
Up there.
That's what they say.
Maybe I have to have mastered.
Thanks,
something.
Brian.
Well. If I know you, you haven't mastered anything.
Me? You are a jerk.
Yeah.
Oh, you.
I have my red in my party, but I can't find him.
How about this? What if you go up?
Should be in his room.
There we go. Maybe this will help. I'm going up. Observatory. Did he just hang out up here somewhere that I don't see him?
Yeah, he's probably just, you know.
I know that if you bring all your masterment, if you've mastered all of any color, you can bring it here. Oh!
We did put the huge materia up here. Huge materia! It's glowing strangely.
Okay. It's cold. Okay.
Okay, they all say that.
Yeah.
We're looking for Bugenhagen. Okay, they say he looks sick. I'm just gonna say it's not missable.
How about Red 13's ultimate weapon?
Do you have Red 13 in your party?
Oh shit.
I said that first!
When do we ever have him on?
Well, while we're doing this, you guys, might be a throwback if you guys haven't seen it, that we've showed it. We only had a camera a couple episodes. Here's the original disc, which we're not playing. They all fall out because none of these things stay in very good shape over the years. The Black Bat, classic one. Again, we're not playing that. We downloaded the port.
Black to back.
3 discs. That was so cool. The more discs you had, the cooler you were back
then. The more fun you're going to have if you have more discs.
Mm-hmm.
Although, disc 3 is very short. Okay, here we go. We can change our party here.
Nice. Nicely done.
I neglected to remember that you had to put Red 13 in your party, but I didn't know so I'm naughty.
The Golden Chocobo, yeah, we had to breed it. And we did most of it off screen, though we've mentioned it kind of briefly here and there. Mostly me. Yeah. Bryce helped a little. No, I did none of it. I've done none of the playing on or off screen. We captured a couple Chocobos. A wonderful blue is what we ended up with. And we mated it with a wonderful...
No?
No, no, I know it perfectly.
No,
we took a polka dot.
Trying so hard to be like, yeah, I think this is what happened.
You took the rainbow colored Chocobo.
Grandfather.
Nanaki, you're still here!
He's sick.
I can't leave you like this, Grandfather.
If this is the finale, what will season 2 be?
It's the duty of Seto's son to guard his canyon and her people.
Listen, Nanaki, I think you may already know. If you have any mission in life, it is not to defend this valley. Look at the withering mountain grass. Listen to the warble of the newborn chocobos.
Work.
Right now. Look always to this eternal flow of time, which is far greater than the span of a human life. I will teach you more than staying here in the valley. What will you see will eventually become part of the life stream for all my children and for your children. So please, Naki, go with Porpoisey and use your eyes, your ears. Your sword! Mostly your sword! Now, don't look like that. I'm clearly all right. It's a big world, and you must go out and see it. You may even find your life's mate. You'll never know.
Grandfather.
Oh yes, take this along. I think it will look good on you now.
What about that last? What about the prolonged hoe?
You'll never hear another prolonged hoe.
Oh, I want my prolonged hoe.
Oh, no. Oh, no. Prolonged hoe, no.
Snoop Lion, is Bubenhagen...
Grandpa told me that he's gonna go away again.
Away?
Seems like he really liked that airship. He told me he couldn't just stay here and just zipped on out. Zip! He even gave me a gift, look!
Limited moon.
Yay!
Wait a minute, aren't you supposed to give gifts after you come back? Grandpa sure is strange. Man, light it up for the man upstairs.
He's just a kid. Anaki's just a child.
The end is drawing near.
Maybe we'll run into him again somewhere.
Sometime. Yeah, maybe. Thanks, Porpoisey. That's a drink.
That's a drink.
Yeah,
there's first one.
I will say the shrugging has gone plummeted since like a couple episodes.
It's just serious to shrug now.
Yeah. Hey, no one's shrugging anything off at this point in the game.
Cassie is asking us here, this is the finale, what will season two be? Are we gonna make that announcement?
I don't wanna call it season two, but our second
play, next foyer.
But
into whatever.
Like a season, I don't know.
Hey, that 17 episodes is a lot.
Yeah, 17 flawless.
Perfect.
So good.
Do you wanna see one announced now then? I'll let you do it.
How about once we get to the number? A special number I'm thinking of, I think you know the number, we've not discussed this, but it's a special number for us in our gaming lives. But once we reach that number...
Of viewers?
Yeah.
Oh. So. And if they don't come, they'll never know.
They will never
know. The best promotion ever. Secrets.
We're gonna get over 7.
No, that's the number. You didn't mean to say it. Alright, let's forge on here. We stopped and drank and I farted around. Okay, so we're at 5 people
still,
now.
Still, the point is still there.
We're going to announce it. Thank you for your interest, Cassie. Sorry for the teaser. I didn't know that was going to come.
It's okay.
Stay tuned. We're going to announce our next game that we're going to play. It's a completely different genre.
Yeah.
Completely different way to play it.
I think having the camera... I bought the camera because I thought it would be better. A better playthrough with...
the next one for sure. This one, I don't know.
Throwing a kiss.
So let's try this limited moon.
So this is the ultimate weapon for Snoop Lion.
Yeah, everyone's which got one. It's super powerful, but only downgrade is the materia growth is nothing. You don't grow any materia in your ultimate weapons. But since we are at the end of the game, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, so you got nowhere to go but up or sideways. Well, hello Jack B and Miranda. Miranda says, yo, Bryce.
Miranda!
And she gives you a kissy face emoticon.
Oh, well, that's
nice.
That's very nice. Appropriate for the holiday.
You don't want to know what Jack B gave you in the emoticons. I won't even say. It's nothing. He's just gonna look. There's nothing there. Let's go.
Sorry.
Let's get out of this menu. I'm gonna start singing menu songs.
I'm gonna have to be menuing a little bit.
This is the end of the game. It's delicate.
I placed the save crystal in an absolutely horrid spot. Right at the opening of the crater. So, I gotta pretty much be flawless when I go there. We're how gonna go to Ultima Sword.
Oh, and just end of the question, real quick. How did you get the gold chocobo? What did you breed to get it? You captured a what and bred it with a what?
There's a chocobo Billy's ranch.
When you gonna come back to Springfield and visit?
It's really, really good.
Yeah.
And it just gives step-by-step instructions. And basically what you have to do, you have to get yourself a wonderful chocobo, which are found in the icicle area. And then you have to breed like a couple goods with each other. I mean, I don't know the exact science. I didn't know.
He cheated.
It.
That's what
I
said.
No, I did everything legit. I did do the 3x speed so I could speed through it. But then you take those two gold and or two good, and they would mate, and they would make a green or a blue chocobo. And then you want to make a green and a blue together to make a black chocobo, and then you would mate the black chocobo with the wonderful chocobo to create the gold chocobo. And this stuff is all told through text if you talk to the right people.
And if you're still awake, you pass the nerd test.
Hello.
I'm just pretending to be awake. No, I get into all that nerd stuff. I liked the chocobo part the first time around. It's as close as you get to any sort of like open world decision-making aspect of this game is to...
Yeah, I did a lot of chocobo racing, and that is where I would never have done it if I didn't have the 3x speed.
Which we can use now to kind of go around quickly.
Yeah.
And just to answer another question here from the chats, where did we get the ultimate sword from for Cloud?
You have to defeat the ultimate weapon. Weapon in all caps.
Did we do that?
We did that.
Yeah, we did. I remember that clearly.
We got the Leviathan scales from somewhere. I forget where. But this is where it's used. The scale of the sea god.
That's a good segue. Thank you, Jack Beaver, for providing me with the perfect segue. So we're going to get a couple weapons, we're going to use our gold chocobo to go to some secret places.
We are. We're going to get a couple extra things. And by the way, I missed... Hopefully you're not watching this playthrough thinking that you're going to find everything. Because we missed old Stevenson's ultimate weapon.
We did.
Yeah, it was in Midgar. It was in the Shinra Tower, and I think we accidentally skipped the Shinra. Steel as well, so you can... equip that with any materia, not any materia, but say lightning, you would send a lightning attack at them, and then you would also steal from them.
That would be nice to have at the beginning of the game.
Oh, by the way, give me that that pocket of tater tots there.
Tater tocket?
Tater tots, you know, like Napoleon Dynamite.
Oh, I got it. When are you going back to Springfield to visit? Comments want to know.
I'm never going back!
There you go. From the mouth of babes.
Well, honestly, I would go back, but it would probably be for my mother, if anything. Or my brother, I guess, whatever.
Neither one lives in Springfield.
That's true, but if I was in that area, I would make an effort to go to Springfield to do... Hopefully they'd let me do some improv. You know, that'd be
as great. Long as they haven't listened to this
hopefully
show.
It's like, we've seen him be doing in Vegas, and, no.
We don't want that here.
No.
I guess we just don't get that almost West Coast type of humor.
No.
Damn it, Bryce.
I did some work on the,
I miss you in our gaming nights.
You know what?
Are we all saved up? You want to save and fight that guy?
Yeah, let's see how we stack up.
What's the time, Hammer Time? We got 9 till 6. We're not in a tight schedule. We'll beat the game when we beat the game! We're getting further away from our goal of announcing our next...
Okay, let's just try it. We have no material on this, by the way.
Oh, he was much bigger than he made it seem. We have no material on us. Is that what you said?
Yeah.
That seems like a good idea.
We're gonna face these guys, but I just want to take a... Okay. Not great. We were heading to use a cosmic memory. Speed it up a bit. I remember.
Now I remember that thing I learned.
That's why he uses the lightest joints. It took 0 away from him.
Good start.
Okay, so that's going to take Porpoise away. Alright.
It's not a finale if we don't die. At least once.
Okay, so we got... Oh my goodness. We gotta strategize. Maybe in the future we'll do episodes where we fight these ultimate weapons. Oh great, more things to fight.
You're all dead.
I
guess Snoop Lion is
just
sleeping.
Snoop Lion is alive? What is he? What? What? What is going on? Can I run away?
Spoiler, season 2 is Minesweeper.
Okay, well, there you go. Even if you're ready to beat the game, which, man, I hope we are, you're not ready to fight those dudes.
They were added to the American version of Final Fantasy VII, which I don't know why the Japanese didn't get them. I'm sure they got
the Japanese
them. I'm sure they got them in some way.
I don't know. I think they realized that the game has a definite ending, but it could be cool if you could just keep going and leveling and just something else to fight besides...
A reason to level up.
Yeah.
But, I mean... I wouldn't say we're over-leveled for the boss, but, I mean, we're pretty much only a couple levels above. Alright, so aside from anything else, let's go get some Chocobos.
Some Chocobos. Well, we already have the Chocobos, so we're going to pick them up from Chocobo Billy.
I think you guys will like the names. If you want to share, that would be great if you want to share this video with other people at this time, because we're going to be casting for a little while here. Because that would be great to get some more people in here.
I would never solicit from you people.
I would. Drew, the female.
Class A.
And we got over here.
Harsh class system.
We got Pino.
Okay, we saw them last week.
Yeah, and did you see the black chocobo? Biggs.
No. So he's named after another fallen comrade in the game.
And I've had Jessie since the beginning, hence the first.
But she's not gold.
That's a wonderful chocobo. S class.
That's the gold one.
Look at that gold.
I see it.
Look at that gold.
It's Wedge.
It's Wedge.
Not from this game, though. From Star Wars. Welcome! Last time we're gonna hear Chocobo Billy.
Well, yeah.
We don't have to say anything.
For being a small pike, I mean, it looks like it could be probably maybe 10.
Brian says, spoiler, season 2 is Minesweeper.
Aw, dude, I had so much fun with that. Do you remember the game that involved... what was it? Do you remember that one?
That's my favorite game. Tell me more about it.
There was a bunch of cheese and rats involved.
Not ringing a bell. Is it on like the old school, like a platformer?
It was like,
this place ain't on the map.
Ah, what is this?
Oh, just right there. It's big. Over the course of many years, Mako energy crystallizes into materia. Received Knights of Round Materia. Oh, that's a trophy.
Sounds
I don't think it's got on the feed. They can't. Roundtable Destruction. Now, this is a very long cinema involved in executing the summon. Luckily, we have a 3X to make. I want to say it's like 8 minutes or 10 minutes or something ridiculous.
Something long.
49 minutes.
Wow.
8 days. 8 human days.
8 human days.
Okay. Now, that is a big old summon.
The gold chocobo basically allows you to have the powers of the blue and the black.
Mountains, water, rivers.
Yeah, it mainly gets you over this dark part. It can go over oceans and sink a little bit.
Oh, that's scary.
Yeah, it's like, oh. Next, we are going to cross this.
Will he attack you while you're on the throne?
Probably.
No, oh, okay.
But I ain't worried.
Good idea. Speaking about season 2, Brush really wanted to play that old Nightmare on Elm Street game.
Oh, no, it's you're thinking Friday the 13th.
Oh, that's right, I'm sorry. Absolutely.
That looks fun.
Frustrating.
That looks
It does look kind of fun.
Yeah, it does look fun to me.
Did I hear they're remaking that in like an open world kind of game? Like, maybe I'm just making that up in my head.
An open world Friday the 13th game?
Mm-hmm. Well, that game was kind of supposed to be open world.
Okay.
Because like you walked around the whole camp and you could... No, I'm thinking of...
Here we go, some more.
Yeah, Friday 13th. Over the course of many years, Mako energy crystallizes into materia. Received HP plus MP.
MP!
Alright, so that is what?
It will switch your... Okay, let me try it out. I'll show you. Okay, we got a lot of new stuff. Okay.
So there's Knights of the Round, steal as well.
Increases your magic by 8. That's pretty crazy. HP, MP, it switches it. So see, I got 5,886. Equip it, it flips it. So that person becomes like super... It's got a lot of...
But they'll die.
Unless you equip them with a bunch of MP. Watch, let's do that. Let's see how that works. Oh man, I really wish I had a chance to do this beforehand.
No, the menu is everybody's favorite part.
Yeah.
It makes such a cool bloop bloop sound that never gets old after 70 hours.
I turned it down a little bit. HP plus. Oh, because I put them on. So if I put, I have a couple mastered MP plus.
Bryce, have you played Dark Souls?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Oh man, that's bad.
Do you want to,
do not want to use that.
Have you ever played Dark Souls?
No, but I've watched a friend of mine play it, and it looks like something that I would not like. Honestly, it looks too hard. I understand there's people out there that there are people out there that want a huge challenge, and those games definitely provide it. But I don't think I want that much of a challenge. As being, I mean, look at me. I'm playing a game I've played like 17 times.
You like no challenge?
I don't like to be challenged in life in general. But
it says something about your status.
Yeah.
Mean that's a drink thing to say.
That's a drink, my.
Hold on a shot on that. Better get some rum. Gonna get rum dumb.
Yeah. You're right. Dude, if this isn't the finale,
I'm gonna so much put it on you. I'm gonna be like, Frice, you fucked us. You had one job, it's just to defeat this game while I sit here and drink.
Well, yeah, I figure I can make good decisions early on, but once I get the alcohol on me, it's like, save crystal right there. That's good. And then later I'm like, what the fuck were you doing? That's
you
terrible.
Wanted to challenge, despite what you just said.
Yeah, well, I think we're getting at 6, so I think we got the things I wanted to get. Let's go to our casa, just one last time.
If you're just joining us here, this is the finale of Bryce and Matt Play That Final Fantasy VII.
Oh.
We are going to check in, get a few secret special things that we are about done with. Oh, don't make wrestling moves at the TV.
Hey.
No, he won't play it.
You won't play Dark Souls, people are saying, aren't you?
Well,
if you're just joining, though, we're going to beat the game here. It's about 6, so we're going to about head that direction. And then, if it's your first time joining and haven't, please subscribe. It's really good for us. You can also follow us on Facebook and find out when we're going to come back on. We don't know exactly when.
Hopefully within the week. Come on, please. If you don't buy from me, I can't pay rent. And no one else will either. Look at these people.
You're all gonna die, man.
Yeah, died.
Let's buy everything.
We don't have cash to buy everything on the dash. We gotta get go. Gotta get. Don't worry about any of it.
Play
no.
Bloodburn.
Gotta go over here, my friend. Talk to the ladies that are giggling.
Giggling.
Oh, ho, ho! It's the end of the world.
She might not be laughing. Is that your Bugenhagen impression?
Yeah, do you know Bugenhagen? Do you know Nanaki's father?
Dude, he's dead. He, like, just died. He's trending on Twitter.
7 people are watching.
Okay.
What?
Are you shitting me?
No. Our announcement for next week. We said when we got to 7 people, at least we'll announce.
I think, before you say this, I think Brian, or somebody out there, one of our loyal listeners, created 2 accounts and then logged in to both of them to get to 7.
Well, so, you know what? I'll take it.
Yeah, that is... hard work.
And if they did last week's homework, they all logged into somebody else's computer and secretly subscribed.
Yeah, okay. Well,
so
I don't want to just come out and say it.
What if I give you a drum roll? Next season...
8! Oh, no, we can't say it.
Season
once
2...
Once we get back to 7,
installment 2 of what we're going to play, Bryce Matt Play That Next, is going to be...
Matt on the sticks.
Me on the sticks.
Yeah. Neither of us have played it. It's a game. Resident Evil... 7?
Resident Evil 7. The camera will be nice for that. You guys will get to see me not only play it for the first time, but hopefully shit myself out of fear.
Yeah, I've played the first hour, and I've stopped.
3-7.
We gotta play this.
And unlike this game, it looks really good. Like, it's brand new. It'll be good. It'll be frighteningly good.
Frighteningly.
Yes.
You want to buy a souvenir to remember participating in the Meteor Chaw?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Dude, I'm going to buy all of your potions.
I'm going to...
Actually, fuck that. I don't...
You don't want that many?
No.
Resident Evil 7, because we only play games with the number 7 in them.
Yes.
We're going to play Mega Man 7 after that.
No. My least favorite one.
We're going to play... I don't even know what other ones are.
Let's see what's going on there.
We're gonna watch Star Wars 7. Don't look at me like that.
The sea breeze, sun, and meteor. It's nature strange, right? It's like nature is strange.
That's a band name, Nature Strange. It's getting closer and closer. Someone will do something, don't you think? Yeah, me.
Yeah.
I'm gonna do it.
Sitting around waiting for Meteor to come. Why has it gotta fall on us, man? Dude!
Ugh. That acting was just... I loved it.
Ugh, leave me alone! I'm trying to learn how to swim before the world ends.
Yeah, that guy's committed.
Yeah.
Leave me alone, I just told you what I'm doing.
One more time. I don't even care if it is the end of the world. I just want to sit here and drink cocktails. Ooh, I drank too much cocktails. So we own this resort, and I pointed out, I think, last episode. Why aren't we making any money on this?
Yeah, everybody's really depressed.
These are our drinks.
Where are these kids' parents? Are they drinking at the bar?
Oh wow, man, that's huge! Whoa, in the sky! Oh my god,
the stars—they're in flames.
That is actually very depressing. That's so scary, dude. I would hate that.
Oh, actually, the only Mega Man game Bryce likes more than 7 is 8. Is that true? Actually, I don't know.
8 is on PlayStation, and I played a little bit of it, and I haven't played enough to really get a full opinion on it. It didn't seem too fun to me. I think your first power-up was like, you kick a soccer ball. And I was like, what the fuck is this?
Hey.
I mean, I guess they were going outside the...
They're hippifying.
Oh, because they had this Mega Man soccer game.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, and it was actually pretty good. That Mega Man soccer game was fun.
Mega Man soccer.
That is one of my favorites.
Let's beat this game!
Okay, sorry, I am...
Let's beat it! What?
I'm scared.
You're scared? Is scary?
I'm scared.
Is he scary?
I'm scared. Sephiroth's
gonna hurt me.
He's gonna hurt me.
That's good snore.
Jeez. My lower back is killing me. I think this is me. Incarnate. I'm sleeping. My back hurts.
Zach, dude.
Yeah. Sir? How do you do? I'm the manager. Nice to meet you. Well, if you pardon me, I'm leaving. Good night.
No, I have some questions about the financial situation of this resort I bought.
Sleeping in my basement.
And I'm not making any money. I paid like 300,000 gil or a million gil or something crazy, right?
I think it was 300,000?
That's one of the two things I said.
Okay.
It's pretty close. A 50-50 chance.
Oh, boy.
Okay, let's beat the game. It's so easy for me to say.
Yeah, exactly.
Just get to your well-placed save point that you got to pick. If anybody thinks it's a bad place, this is the guy to chat about it with.
Chat about it.
Oh, Phantom Pain. Well, we did take suggestions last week.
Phantom Pain.
You weren't there. No, I'm just kidding.
It would have to have taken a pretty strong suggestion.
Yeah, we already pretty much had that in mind.
Yeah, I mean, what was last week? It was Ace Attorney? No, that's not Ace Attorney, but... some detective game that Drew had.
Oh yeah, I don't remember what it was called off the top of my head. I'd have to go back to the comments and check. I drink heavily when we play.
Me too.
So I don't know if you guys have noticed that it affects my short-term memory.
Okay. So
regarding what occurs.
I guess that's it. So going to the Northern Crater. This is so scary. Oh my god, there's so much resting on us. Step aside for a second.
Also, Resident Evil 7 won't be nearly as long as this game, I'm guessing.
It won't. I don't think. I've heard it's a short game, which...
But I'm going to die a lot.
Sure, and I think that's kind of part of the fun of it.
You guys are going to see me rage quit.
It's so scary, dude.
Looks like we can only slide down. All right, let's get ready first. I can bind the phone.
All right, let's go ready first.
Let's go ready first. That should be our name of the episode there. Let's get ready first. What are you?
Let's get ready first.
Right. That's the threatening kick right there. That's frightful. Alright. Let's slide down is the only way.
Okay.
But you've been down here before and got back up somehow, didn't you?
Yeah, you can get back up.
That's misleading.
So there's no enemies down here.
Is that the one you placed?
Yeah.
Perfect.
God, it's right at the beginning of the damn thing.
Oh, not the end of it. I see first.
All right. PHS, you can't use the PHS in here? That's fucked up. I have to switch my team. I do not want to...
No! No!
Dude, this is great.
We're professionals.
Oh my god.
You're just tuning in and are wondering.
Oh my god. Follow me at Bryce Versa.
I mean save.
Don't follow
Twitter.
Don't follow
if you do Twitter.
I'm not even gonna tell you where.
If you don't do Twitter, sign up and make that the person you follow.
Do both.
Welcome. Everyone's waiting for you.
They tell me to pee and save first, but I think
this is a good idea. Who am I gonna take down here? I'm gonna take,
you tell me.
Who needs it? Who needs to come down and get some levels? Hey, we're here to save the world. We're going with the original party.
Nice. I think it's a good choice. Don't forget to materia them up.
Of course, yes. Let's go. Wait.
If you're just joining, guys, welcome. We're about to go beat the game.
Yeah.
Looks like we got a couple of new people in the mix tonight.
Yeah, it'd be awesome. I'd like to do some more promoting on my social medias.
You should try being funny.
But I have to do this.
No, I meant on your social media and in life. I'm saying you're not funny. But it's not true.
Hardly funny.
I think you're hilarious.
Wait, can we get her at her final limit? That'd be nice. Final heaven. Yeah. Heck yeah. Heck yes. Okay.
Anyway,
I just want to hear some music here too. This is the part where we need to talk to the audience a bit more. If you want to lead that, because I need to think about this a
menu
bit.
Menu time.
You know what I'm saying?
All right, he's going to go in and...
I mean, if you want to tell a story, maybe...
About snakes?
Tell a Resident Evil story.
Okay.
Because,
I have a good one.
Okay.
Probably. I played a lot of Resident Evils. The first one I played...
Talk to them, because I'm just going to, like, be...
No, I'm going
to
look right at your... Okay. I'm also going to kind of pet your shoulder a little, really bother you.
Okay.
Now, he's going to get his menu all set up. I played Resident Evil 2 was the first one I played, or as the announcer says in the beginning...
Yeah, Resident Evil. Yeah.
And I played it on the Nintendo 64, which I guess I'm the only person alive to do that. I thought it was really cool. I personally also like Nemesis quite a bit. I played Resident Evil 2, which is why this is stuck in my mind, with my dad. He watched me play most of the whole game.
Of what game?
Resident Evil 2.
He watched you play most of
that? He wanted to kind of trade back and forth, but he just didn't have the... skills, and
yeah,
he liked to throw the controller.
It was cool because it was like a cinematic experience.
Yeah, and really kind of everyone's in the same playing field because of the, what do they call that kind of control they have in that game? I can't think of the word.
Tank control.
Thank you. It kind of levels everybody, and it was new to me at the time, so. He watched me play most of it. I'd call Jason or Logan or probably Kevin whenever I had a question. I didn't have them guide. I also played it way... Final Fantasy VII I played way later, but I think I played Resident Evil 2 pretty soon, as soon as it was released on the 64, which is still probably a year later. Everybody else played it on the old PlayStation.
64 had blood. I think 64 is the definitive Resident Evil 2.
Oh yeah?
I've heard
people say that. You could make the blood off or make it green, turn it off or make it green colored. I think it had maybe some different difficulty settings and stuff. I'm excited because I haven't played Resident Evil's several of the last ones. I played a little bit of 4, but I didn't play 5, didn't play 6. I have probably haven't played one in a decade, so it'll be fun to get back in there, see what they brought back from the old version to the kind of the reboot. Looking forward to seeing, I'm hoping, some like first aid sprays, some herbs I can mix. There better be some creepy dogs and creepy birds. I want a creepy dog and a creepy bird in every episode.
Creepy dog bird.
Creepy dog bird.
Give me a creepy dog bird in there.
Give me creepy dogs, please.
I heard Resident Evil Survivor is, like, trash. Is that true?
That's what I've heard. I bought it for my friend, I don't know if he's listening tonight, for Jason. I don't know if he... I never played it. I think he did. Years ago. It was their first attempt at first person. But it was like a shooter kind of game. It was to compete with the James Bonds and the... Probably Halo was out by then, even. But the new Resident Evil doesn't seem like that. It seems like a mix of, like, kind of... I don't know. It seems kind of original. I'm not sure I played anything quite like the new Resident Evil.
It was very scary. I'm like, I don't want to play this by myself. I need to play this for somebody else.
Well, great. I just told you I don't know if I'd ever play one again, but I didn't know the reboot was coming out when I said that. I didn't know it looked so cool.
It's so cool.
The graphics, some of the ones I saw looked like photographs.
Yeah, it's just, I mean, like I said, I only played a little bit of it, but it looks so real. And at times, sometimes it doesn't. But,
I mean, let's play something relevant that looks good, something we can make fun of for different reasons. I'm gonna make fun of this because it's kind of antiquated. It doesn't look good. I'm not convinced it's fun. I'm not convinced this is a fun game after playing it again.
This?
Yeah. I don't think I'd play it again alone. I mean, this is kind of the same reason we chose this one. It's like we both wanted to kind of play it again, but neither one of us wanted to sit down alone in a room for 50 plus hours.
I really wanted to.
What's our menu ETA here?
God, I'm trying, dude.
I know you are. I'm not Russian.
It's a lot. You gotta think
I'm
about
not Russian.
Something like, because we're going into a very dangerous part of the game. I think we're gonna make Penelope the physical, hard-hitting person.
Choking on these.
They're choking.
We're chocoboing.
Chocoboing. I'm gonna go ahead and add a sneak attack to her. I'm gonna give her the.
So this is
effect.
Important because I'm sure this is a very long battle. Sephiroth is a big bad dude if you've been watching our previous episodes. And he's gonna try to kill us. Like, murder us. That's not nice. He
might succeed too.
And he did already murder somebody in our group.
Survivor was kind of fun, I thought, for a rail shooter.
He gets up.
Yeah, was that, who was that said that?
Featherton said that. Survivor was kind of fun, he thought, for a rail shooter. I never played it. I also really like the Resident Evil Outbreak game, which was online. I didn't have online capabilities for my PlayStation 2. But the single player was still very fun. It was kind of puzzle-solving, different endings. It was cool. Kind of the first sort of open-world zombie game. Did you play Dead Island?
Dead Island? No.
I played a little bit of it.
Resident Evil 4, did you like it?
I did like it. I was really just hurt that they changed it around and I missed the tank controls and I didn't think that this should be their sole direction. I was like, why can't they still make an old kind of...
It sold the GameCube to me. Like, when it was in GameStop, I stepped in there. It's like my first month in Springfield, Missouri. It was January 05, and I was like, I played it in there. I was like, this is amazing. I mean, Mario Kart Double Dash is also really awesome. Just amazing game. Like, it's... I mean, everybody loves it. That's what they say, right?
I probably played the first 5 or 10 hours twice, you know, and then I just got distracted.
Where was I at? I think I was freezing.
It's scary for a different reason, you know, than the old games. Also, this new Resident Evil game, I believe, is R-rated, or MA, or whatever. It's got, so I think, violence, more violence, and more language, and more realistic stuff. You know, that violence. And violent language.
It's scary, man. It's like, it's a trippy kind of game. Attack.
Anybody out there playing these survival games like Minecraft or Ark or there's a bunch of new ones coming out. I think it'd be cool to have a zombie game like that. There's a couple like DayZ, but they never came to fruition. I mean there's Dead Island. It's got a bit of a linear story. It was kind of weird when you play Dead Island because you're playing offline, but other people are playing and you'll see them like run through your like you're kind of online but kind of not. And they made a sequel to the game. I'm not sure if they kept that up.
Alright. I think I'm done.
You are all equipped. No one is gonna die. Sephiroth is gonna get Geneva's ass handed to him.
Genova.
Geneva, tomato, tomato.
Tomato, tomato.
Vincent. It's me, Vincent. I have a heart to play flip. Hello, people just joining us. Perfect timing to see us defeat Final Fantasy VII. You're going the wrong way.
I'm trying to do some melee casting here.
You'll never do it well.
Okay.
Gargoyles, even.
Trick these
Rain
guys.
Rain 4 is my favorite for sure.
RE4 is Thousand's favorite.
Yeah.
I know you got crazy on the mercenaries for one. That was your thing.
I do remember playing like a horde, like you fought wave after wave on 4 or 5, I don't remember which one. At somebody's house, probably your guys'.
Take that.
That did not hurt him very, oh, I mean, okay. Didn't kill him.
So, it's dangerous. L4 death. Good. If any of our team members are, if their level is a multiple of 4, then that will cause instant death for them. And a lot of the enemies in this crater will cause instant death. There's L5 death, which, you know, same thing. Like, let me check here. Nobody's L5, nobody's a multiple of 4 or 5 right now. But, as we gain levels, that will change. Okay, we're just working our way down the crater. This is the point where
that's
I
that's your favorite sexual move, isn't it?
Working down the crater?
Working your way down the crater.
Yeah. Axe wound! Alright. Gyarados. We're gonna give that to Barry.
You know what this ending needed? More menus.
Okay. You dick.
I ate M&M's and now my mouth is full and I can't provide my hilarious color commentary.
Color commentary. I snorted.
You did.
That means I thought my own joke was really funny.
There's that materia there.
Oh, and a battle right here. Oh,
I got your battle right here.
You want to fight a dragon?
Oh, man, dragon.
Yeah, you gotta fight a dragon sometimes, but...
Oh, don't sometimes do that. You gotta fight a dragon.
Dragon.
Fight a dragon. Time to fight. She's got a lot of those reels by now.
That was a counterattack there.
They punched me.
If you attack this dragon with magic, it will counterattack with a deadly laser.
Ooh.
So do not attack it with magic.
Is it an instant death laser?
Yeah, you need to suplex with a dolphin blow. The dolphin blow.
The lethal porpoise blow.
Yeah. Porpoise. See, they're connected. Yeah, what life.
I'm hoping there's a nice new battle song at the end of this. I don't know.
There will be some new battle songs. So we got the HP absorb, we have that, but...
Can't have too many.
Nah, power source. We'll get that to all... Nah, fuck, we'll do it. Once we get to the end. We'll get a lot of sources at the end. Porpoisy sources.
And we always cite our sources.
Yeah. Cite them. What? Quit climbing.
Why are you climbing, Cloud?
You need to be jumping and crawling.
Okay. Jumping and crawling, not climbing.
Just fucking
going down.
Okay. Oh, come on, I have enemy away on. So that should mean, okay, we got scissors here.
That's not the enemy away icon, is it?
How about fire 3? You like fire? Because we got a level 6
icon. That's a cool looking, kind of like 70s Elvis kind of inspired looking robot.
Scissor, what?
Clearly he's wearing like an Elvis like white polyester suit with like some colored like diamond decals on the side.
You can get a lot of AP from those guys. They slice in half, but I did not give them a chance. Just because I'm so worried about dying. I'm like beyond scared.
Wait, you don't think you're going to die in this battle? I don't think you're
like,
going to die in this battle.
I think I have a...
Bob, what's your favorite game?
Did they ask you what your favorite game
is? No. They don't come here to talk to us, Bryce.
Magic source. Who are they talking to?
Kevin would like to know Featherman's favorite game.
Oh.
Double Dribble. Is my guess.
There's a box up there I need to get.
Now we're going backwards.
Yeah, but I'm gonna turn the speed on.
What can we need that bad this close to the end of the game? Well, what could we possibly need?
I'm not taking chances, man. This is the serious battle for the fight for the. By the way, I've been calling the world Eos. It's not. It's Gaia. Gaia.
Yes, not even close.
Yeah, you're right.
What is Eos?
I don't think it's some other game. I guess.
Some other game.
All right. Let's see here.
You just are tuning in. We got a couple new people there. We're about to beat Final Fantasy VII finally after 17 or so installments. Be sure to subscribe and follow us and all that fun stuff.
Yeah, at Bryce and Matt. And that, if you visit that Twitter, that will give you links to
the rest of our stuff.
Both of our Twitters, yeah. If you so wish.
Also, we made an announcement. We are announcing the next game we're going to play. After this one, keeping with our themes of sevens for 2017, we are playing Resident Evil 7. That was the big announcement. It's all over the Twits. Don't check to see what's trending. Just trust me, it definitely is.
Yeah. Along with L.A. Rain.
Gaia is the Greek personification of Earth.
Oh, there you go. Is that how they spell it, Bryce? G-A-I-A? Is that how they...
I believe so.
Oh, there you go. That's what it's inspired from. Thank you.
I'm missing some shit. I'm sorry. I'm missing it.
All right, we'll miss it forever. That's how the cookie crumbles in Gaia.
Yeah, we got some party shit going on.
All right, some acting. The road splits in two. We'll split into two groups, like every good horror flick.
What you gonna choose, Porpoisey? Left or right?
We're gonna go left, right?
Yeah.
Left, right.
Mm-hmm. All right, then I'll go. I'll go left.
Then I'm going left.
All right.
All right, then I'm going right. I'm going right.
Then I'll head right. Right. Then I will go
right? This is lame. This is dumb.
All right, I'm headed right.
I don't really know.
Yeah, I don't know either. Now, don't any of you die on me. Ugh. Gotta get through to Sephiroth.
No! I'll destroy that Sephiroth before anyone gets to him.
I doubt it. Yeah. That would be an anticlimactic ending.
Yeah.
Oh, Sid did it for you. That's good.
It's all over now with this.
I'm all.
Oh, man. Materia Hunter, a yuppie. Sounds like a last chapter of Materia Forever. What the fuck does that mean?
She's gonna write a book.
Materia Forever.
Yeah, last chapter. It's gonna be called that.
Written by a 16-year-old.
All life on this planet. Indeed, the very life of this planet is in our hands.
Ugh, that's hard. Probably a toss between RE4YE, Metal Gear Solid 5 Phantom Pain, or Silent Hill 2.
I'm so happy to have met you all, really. We can't stop and listen to that every time it talks. You're like, This'll be the end of it.
That's it, right?
Both this podcast and this game. Dumb, gonna be dumb on rum. Tonight, Bryce is drinking Kraken Rum. Tonight's show is sponsored by Send Us Some Free Kraken Rum. Kraken. Let's get it Kraken. You think that's their catchphrase? This should be. Let's get Kraken. Don't read it.
The Kraken... Oh, no, no. Oh, it's in, like, calligraphy, so it's, like, really hard to write or read. The Kraken is imported rum
Metroid
from the Caribbean.
Zero Mission is good, too. What's yours? What are the drinking rules?
Okay, drinking rules are every time someone shrugs, every
character.
Time the characters morph into each other.
Yeah, they'll look like, you know. What else was there? When we leveled up, we did it.
Well, limit breaks are still in action.
Limit breaks.
We haven't been doing that for limit breaks, by the way.
Another fork in the road. Who's supposed to do that right?
Porpoisey, which way you gonna choose?
Down? I mean, up.
I really don't remember.
Then down. Should we look?
I'm gonna go up first.
All right, I'm
either
going...
Either Super Metroid or Ocarina.
I'll go up.
Okay, let's
go
then. I
don't go by myself.
No. They did it. Whoa. They did it. They stuck together. Drink.
I need to turn these on. I just took a shot.
I know.
Fuck that.
That's what you get for drinking shots.
Okay, so I got a nagabigai. This areola.
So those are drinking rolls. Shrugging, leveling up, limit breaks, and something else. I already forgot. Because okay, we're too good at the drinking games.
Shrug and shrug, limit break and bake.
You gonna get them all?
What are the other ones?
I'm asking you.
I'm gonna try to. All the boxes?
No. Limit break is the other one.
Limit break, yes.
And there's a fourth one. Also, if they talk about drinking, we'll do it.
Yeah, if they talk about drinking.
Which happens there?
I like this music.
We got Ocarina of
What's
Time mentioned.
Statement?
Oh, we got more coming in. I'll shut up for a second so I can read. Yeah, this is all fun. This is going on. Anybody out there played the sequel to Ocarina of Time, Majora's Mask? I very much enjoyed it. I think I'm the only one.
I enjoyed it. I used the guide. Shield material. Look at that. Whoa. Imperial Guard.
What's with the teleporting?
You're going through the water.
Hmm. Just like it sounds.
Okay,
so, a lot of treasure before the end of the game.
Yeah, it's like, here's a bunch of stuff.
What they wanted to... I mean, they think you're going to die.
Well, I turned the battles off because I'm really worried that I'm going to die. We encounter one of those thorn berries. I've opened a couple chests in here already. Okay.
Cheats. We've been cheating.
I've been cheating?
We're going to beat the game any minute.
Cheating, skeeting. No?
No.
Cheating, skeeting ain't working?
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Or cheating or beating it. None of those are going to work.
Beaten and skeeted.
No.
How do I get out of here? Okay.
You're asking me? Oh, you jump on the thing. Why don't we all do that? Now we go the other way.
So, this is kind of confusing.
I have not played any of these games, but my new hobby is baking bread. Anybody got a favorite bread?
I had like a crazy craving this morning for monkey bread.
Oh. We'll leave this to Tito.
Oh,
okay. That's a specific craving.
Yeah, man, I really want monkey bread. But it was only like for like a 5 minute period.
Olive.
Olive bread. We'll try to go down from the other side.
Okay, so I guess I gotta go this way. Like I said, I have been to this part of the game.
Bread
so.
Maker or no bread maker?
I would like the physical, the tangible act of actually making the bread.
Haven't taken that step yet.
I've not made a lot of bread in my life. I mean, I made a couple pizza crusts.
Does monkey bread count?
W magic.
It's bread, right?
It counts. Baby. What's this bowl?
That's out of the soul of the earth, of course.
Yep.
We all know about the
is that something?
Earth soul.
Can I grab it? Counter material.
Oh.
Okay. There you go. I think you were trying to enact. We went over. Oh no! This looks like the end.
This is the end.
I don't argue with the star of the show.
That's right. I actually don't prefer monkey bread. It's too soggy.
Too soggy? Well, it's like a dessert bread.
I get it. I just don't like it.
You don't like it?
I get it, but I don't like the monkey bread. All right, Turbo Ether, just what we need.
It refills all your magic.
Oh, yeah.
You feel so.
Don't I know it.
You get your feel. Hey, Absinthe.
Well, I'm kind of busy beating the game here. You can't see me, but I'm doing important things.
Yeah, you went down the right path. We went down the left with Porpoising. I was just wondering, I don't know. Do you think Penelope's cute?
Oh, I'm an asexual being, man. I'm a fucking stuffed animal with a cat on top of it.
Look, I know you're brave. I know that you just hang out in our room and you just kind of spy on us. And it ain't gonna happen no more. Nah.
Are you calling me on the phone? How are we having this conversation?
Yes, I'm using the PHS. Oh,
then I'm not afraid of you. Fuck off!
Hey, you toy son of a bitch.
I have Majora's Mask for 3DS. Haven't played yet.
I didn't know that was on 3DS.
What are they talking about?
They're talking about Majora's Mask.
Oh.
On 3DS.
Oh, that game is tough to play.
That game is
There's a lot of things to take into consideration when playing Majora's Mask.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
I can't do that once.
Yeah, well, I can barely do it.
It's a skill.
I'm pretty much just doing a Stone Cold E.T.
E.T.?
Yeah, there's a YouTube video called Stone Cold E.T. and he goes to a White Castle and he's like got a E.T. mask on and he's doing Stone Cold's impression.
Hello,
that's
now.
Really the inspiration for what I'm doing.
I've not seen that.
Thanks everybody for joining in for us. This is, I think, the highest we ever had, maybe?
No, we've had, I mean, oh, today.
We've had like 1,000 before.
Well, we're always having 1,000 people.
We understand that the finale isn't going to draw that many people, so we understand how it's going to go.
Dude, I'm so hip that I got so many Hotmail inbox letters that my AOL crashed.
I can't believe it.
My Netscape wouldn't even open up.
Is it okay that we're skipping enemy battles?
Yeah.
Let's fight one.
Oh, you're going to get the pod you don't want to get.
Oh, shit.
Is it him?
Oh, God, no. What am I gonna do? Okay.
Kill him.
I gotta put the death force on everybody. He's really hard to kill.
Hot pocket. CM,
have you baked a
special bread for the finale? I have put cinnamon and raisins in my bread, but haven't actually made cinnamon raisin bread.
Oh god. I'm protecting all of my members from instant death, which is what this character is all the whole about.
The whole reason he's been skipping the battles is because he was afraid of getting one of these. And then right at the end here, second guess himself. So we'll do one battle. And yeah. Sure enough, it's one of those motherfuckers.
But they give you tons of AP. Although it doesn't matter since it's end game.
Jennifer Silvey says Hotmail, Hot Pocket.
Hotmail, Hot Pocket. Hey, we got Porpoise in the
totally.
Team.
That's Heck the yeah. only reason I decided to make bread today, Bubble Loaf. That sounds awesome, CM. Sweet.
Welcome
breads.
Back to.
Hey, we got a lot of win breaks, although I spammed bread. Them. I didn't mean to be spamming them.
No.
I'm trying to pour a shot into my fucking drink.
Into your fucking drink. You're gonna be too drunk to fight Sephiroth.
Kraken. Kraken,
yeah, you're gonna get to Kraken. That's a lot of cuts. He's gonna be wounded.
I made that, Jesus that's a tone barrier. Recently.
That's a.
It was a sweet disaster.
That's a classic.
Sweet brother Thymus SP.
Or enemy is the tone barrier. It will just. It's known for just killing you instantly.
What a
being
jerk.
Very being very dangerous.
What a jerk.
What a jerk of sorts.
I
bags.
Promise next time, no more.
Jerks.
Thorn berries. What are they called?
Tone berries.
Tone berries. They're ridiculous. I don't know what they're called. I won't stand for it. Kennedy says.
Emoji okay. face with stuck out tongue and winking eye.
I couldn't understand that one.
I love this song.
Oh, she's telling us what emoticon he sent. It says something like squinty face, tongue out, winking one eye. I couldn't. Like, I was winking one eye.
Oh, man. I can't really. I mean, I guess I can. I'm going to do it right now. Tell you how thankful I am for you guys all joining throughout the span of these episodes. You know, sometimes you can't make it, sometimes you can, and they'll be there in the ether for who knows how long until we delete them or
lose the account login.
Yeah, which is very possible. Woo!
Stone cold it.
I just picked up a speed source. Oh, hell yeah!
I just mixed in a Macho Man hand. what is that called? Mannerism. Sorry.
I was watching Spider-Man, the movie. The
Spider-Mannerism?
It was not good, but Macho Man's in it. I didn't know that.
Ooh, you got the Macho Man.
That was definitely a voice I was thinking about adding in, but I just didn't feel like it fit the character of Sid.
So many people, so many parties.
So many people!
I think
so
I haven't appreciated
parties.
The artwork of this game until watching this.
Oh, well, that's what they say. Brandon said he's not sure he's appreciated the artwork of the game until watching.
Oh, I mean, yeah, this is cool. You're like going down a skeleton's.
And the cutaway scenes are really good. The FMVs, as Bryce has got me calling them. The FMVs.
Full motion video.
Oh no, music got seriously gone. It's just windy now.
Oh boy. In here. That's the place I've already been. What's the time?
Oh, it is 6:36. Hammer time.
Hangover?
Go down the steps.
I can't let you guys go by yourselves. You'll make me worry. Whoosh!
Okay.
Why is this voice repeating all the
this
comments?
This is the center of the planet. This is it.
Hey, Porpoisey! I found this on the way.
Speed source.
Thanks, Tito.
All right, this is the last dance in the squared circle. Porpoisey, I found this.
Main source.
Because it is God's duty.
I, Porpoisey, I found this.
It's Bryce's robot.
Hold on to this!
What?
By the way, hey Yuppie, didn't you find something on the way?
No.
All
How
right.
do you like it, Grandma?
Here, Porpoisey.
But I'm the one who found it. So you better give it back to me when you're done with it.
It's a consumable.
God.
Let's get going.
Oh man, I am stressing out right now.
No, you got it. There's a save point coming up too, right?
No, there isn't.
That's the only one.
That's
I see.
The
That's
only
the
one.
Whole point. Okay.
Oh my god, dude.
Well, let's do it.
No, not yet.
Okay.
What can I do? I can't PHS here. Okay, so
we weren't sure if the robot voice reading the comments came out over the video until about an hour before we went on, and we forgot to change the settings. So.
What happened?
They're asking. They just like, why is this voice reading all the comments?
Do they like it?
I don't think anybody likes it.
I like hearing it say the comment.
I do.
Hi, Courtney McAuliffe.
And I can hear it. Courtney McAuliffe is in there.
Yeah. But she just said she liked hearing it say, Kevin made her say, how do you like it, Grandma? And it was quite humorous. You were working hard, but we were enjoying that.
I love it. I heard it. I heard someone say, Grandma. Let's get going.
All right, everyone. Let's mosey.
His catchphrase.
His famous catchphrase.
Again? Stop saying it like a wimp. Can't you say, move out? Or something like that. Something cool. Like that.
Move out. Let's fucking do it.
Alright, let's go. Giddy up, little doggy.
What? What?
Look at that number. Shit.
Dinku bring my grandmama into this.
Porpoising, you go first. You got balls of steel.
Okay, I'm going alone.
What?
Shut up. It won't do us no good with everybody back here.
Stevenson's right. You take two of us with you and go first. The rest will catch up with you later.
Is this like a practice run before the final battle?
Yeah, a major practice run.
I'm fine with that. It's probably more fun than meeting Sephiroth down here.
Is that a corn lyric?
This might be fun to pass time. Ha ha.
They're coming! They're already on the next floor! Next to us!
Borbacy, hurry up and make your mind up!
Let's just keep our crew. And we'll send.
We gotta make a couple of parties. Here's what I'm thinking.
Is that a corn lyric?
Don't you bring a grandma into this? Don't you bring a grandma? Don't you?
Don't you come out of my
Don't you bring a grandma, not a team of raw.
Don't you bring a team.
Give me a fuel, give me a fire, give me a
double. Oh, we're doing corn!
I know, but I'm just saying, like, funny lyric. How about we make a party? We have to make two parties.
Oh, you want to take my shirt off? We're going to make a party? Taking my shirt off and make a party.
Would it?
Yeah.
I'll do it.
No, I don't really want
to. I'll do it. I'll do it.
I was being facetious.
Okay. Holy shit.
Facetious.
No.
How about a group of characters voiced by you and a group of characters voiced by me?
Oh, okay. Well, whatever you say. In that case, then it'll be Vincent, Absinthe, and Penelope.
Porpoisey has to be in the team.
Oh, that's true, of course. So then, whichever two you want, let you do it. You gotta fight this battle. I just have to make fun of you when you die.
We'll see about that.
I don't think you're gonna die much.
Okay, we'll put Vincent, Penelope, and
Porpoise
together.
The final battle. Okay. All Matt, all the time over there on the left.
Ribbon, he's got that on him. Okay.
My Kate Sith is better than my Vincent, I'll say that. That's a drink.
Boom.
You don't have to.
Yeah.
All
I
of you.
I think I have to.
All of you, talking to all of you.
How about I do?
Later. Oh, heartfelt, porpoisey.
Yeah, later.
Woo!
Here we go.
Woo!
I'm gonna need more booze to make this happen.
Watch out, bud.
I just gotta squeeze through our
This is intense, man. Alright.
That's why I need glitter.
This is the oh god, I am feeling it right now, dude. I'm scared. Gotta put it to the test. So we just took out Stevenson. He took it very hard.
Yeah, he wants to fight in the final battle.
I really wanted to fight, but you decided to put that dead son of a bitch in there.
He's got two guns, and you only have one.
Let's give him. What does he got? Comet, fire, barrier.
Don't drink in boss fight.
Yeah, shit, dude, you are right. I wish I could Okay, let's give him a time.
Don't drink in boss fight.
Time all. Sure, let's do it. We can do this. It shouldn't be that hard.
I mean, I've definitely drunkenly gotten into Ark and regrettably lost too much stuff because I was too drunk to play Ark. So don't drink in boss fight is a good.
Well, it's already been done.
It's a rule I always break. In fact, it's a rule I exclusively break. Here we go.
Is your sound only coming through your right ear?
Yeah, but it has been that way for, like, I think, always.
Each boss hit over 300 HP, drink.
That's gonna be all of them, but...
Oh god, what's that?
What? I didn't even see.
Oh shit. Oh no.
That's body tail.
That wasn't too bad,
Bad that it suggests we drink every time it's over at 300 HP.
Oh, check this. Check this out.
I'm pretty sure that's the story of everyone I know who has ever played Ark.
I'm looking.
Yeah, no one's played Ark. Look at this.
Sounds like Courtney's played Ark.
Courtney.
Alright, so we turned into a chainsaw dude? Oh yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Cut him!
I mean, this is one of the limit breaks I never saw. You hadn't have a 3x speed or the patience as a child to be like, yeah, let me kill however many enemies to get a limit break. Like, it's... Oh, by the way, should we have his final limit break? We need to actually set his limit break to his final. Because we got it. We visited Lucretia!
Lucretia! Lucretia!
Hey, Vincent.
Yes?
I made you this. This pie.
Because
I know that soon enough, we're going to be splitting ways
so
after we save the world.
It's easy
you
to
want to do it well, fail.
Then you get eaten and lose everything.
Yeah, I figure you're going to have a long nap. Want to have plenty of carbohydrates and sugars to keep your dreams interesting.
Oh, fail. Just taking life here. But wait!
It's a carrot cake.
Is there garlic in this?
Excuse me?
Is there garlic in this cake?
Yeah, I put garlic in the carrot cake. What of it?
I'm a vampire! I'm dying!
I am so sorry!
Give me a phoenix down!
Oh, here, I'm out of phoenix downs.
Matt told me to buy all of them.
I should have listened.
Am I getting my ass kicked? I think I am. I'm sorry, I gotta cheat. I'm really sorry, I cheated. I'm so bad.
Oh, you cheaty? Oh, you cheating McGrady.
I'm really drunk. I'm sorry. Is that a good reason?
Well, you know, we don't want to watch you die again. We all know
it's
you need to cheat.
I'm going
to
try as best I can. Asbestos.
As
I can.
Best as you can.
Oh, he put a barrier on himself, so that's it.
So you're going to try as best as you can to not cheat, you're saying?
Yes. I mean, honestly, you haven't really done a lot in the playthrough. I feel like early on we did. Just kind of get through the Midgar section. Is everybody cool with the Resident Evil 7? Are people looking forward to
it? I didn't hear a negative comment about it.
Or a positive one.
No, I heard several positive.
Oh, good.
I just didn't read them out loud.
I just feel like that's going to be a lot of fun.
Someone said yay, someone said oh yeah, things along that. Someone said cool. Hot Pocket, of course. No, I'm kidding.
That's a good...
I'm cool with it.
This shows
we
how bad
yes,
I am.
We got a woohoo, we got a Resident Evil 7. Yeah.
Yeah, I bought it on release day, and I played a few hours of it, and I was just like, this is really scary.
Now, was it 1 hour? Was it a few hours?
I mean, I played the first part of it a couple
times. Basically the same as Stretch Armstrong. I know you need the confirmation to move forward.
Thanks for the confirmation. CM's right.
Oh, God. Hey, this is, Venison's. Final limit break. He turns into a giant gargoyle?
It's like a bat type, but it's a...
I would call it a...
Goldar from...
I feel like a bat has a smaller body. A gargoyle has like more of a human body with wings.
Oh, fuck you, Bryce.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, we hit a knife. Hey.
Ooh.
Steve comes out of the neck. So there's just a bunch of big-ass monsters
saber.
Between us and Sephiroth.
Oh, I'm going to slice you with my gargoyle might.
The truth is, if they said, don't play that game, you guys suck, I think we still would.
It's our channel. I mean, we kind of could do it.
Yeah, I'm going to play that game anyway.
We are limited to PS4 games.
Well, for the moment, at least.
I mean, yeah.
Whoa, where are we? What's this? Genova? It's coming. All right, so we're gonna fight Genova.
Did you guys ever watch the 90s cartoon Gargoyles?
All right.
Lucretia dot dot my reflection.
You got a posse?
Yes.
Look, show them what you wrote. Listen to this handmade note.
I don't know. I made some notes. some notes for the final section.
Only
of the
episode
game.
We've done this for. Yes. Made any notes for.
No, well, it's a really a learning episode.
I remember the Gargoyles animated movie.
This is the Genova synthesis. I wanted to read this paragraph from the Final Fantasy Theatrhythm game because I thought it was very poignant since it's, you know, it's like, I never played that game.
You
it's like a rhythm game.
The show?
I think it's like a Guitar Hero, but with like all Final Fantasy songs.
Okay.
So, and it has like, you know, you can win different stuff. I never played it before, but basically here's what I wanted to read. Regarding this boss, the Genova synthesis.
Okay.
Countless pieces, Gargoyles long divided. Hey, stop talking. Countless pieces.
Don't talk to the robot like that.
Countless pieces, long divided, shall come together again in the end. To devour the planet, Genova's cells reunite to give rise to this complete form in order to destroy all life and to cut short the life of the planet in the planet's future. All right. I thought that'd be interesting.
I like that.
Here you go.
Oh, okay. Should I just cut it?
Yeah.
All right.
You can build a barrier if you can.
Okay, who has that?
So magic is like a wall.
Perfect. I'll do that.
I don't remember watching the show.
Haste, what was the first thing? Barrier?
Barrier and haste are your important things to do first. And then just...
I find it hard to believe Fawberton didn't watch Gargoyles.
Just play attack. I haven't played in like...
Yeah, I haven't played in 10 years. I can't find barrier at all. There it is. In barrier or just normal?
Some angry slaps and tickles dead.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay,
yeah, I'm doing all right. This is an awful choice, but... Haste, you said? On myself?
I'm sorry, I left no
alone. You did an awful time to give somebody the sticks. Okay, I need some health. Who's got that? Penelope?
One of them does just magic, and she doesn't have it.
Cure 3.
Cure 3. Do it all.
Okay, we're hasted, we're barriered, or walled. Oh, you missed. You're just a brainwad. You're a Krang wannabe. You can't smack me. I'm not having it.
The stuff that attacks all sides, you want to get rid of those arms first.
Oh, is that true?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I was doing the opposite.
The hand will regenerate. Something else in here.
Yeah. So I should focus on the arms with all my attacks.
Yeah, something like attack all. So slash all, two cut, two axe cut, comment two,
which is
in the magic section.
Wow. Alright, not killing us yet. Kept us alive. All right, here you go. I feel like I'm a masterful player of the game. My commentary dropped to 0, but.
You can see how hard it is.
Yeah. I could have used the arm knowledge a bit earlier, but.
So yeah, in our next playthrough, we will really get an idea of how good I am at being commentary-ative.
Your commentatory?
Commentatory.
Commentator tots?
Commentator tots, commentator tots. I think every time you kill the head, it adds like an extra amount of HP to the final boss. Everybody's in Berserk? Is that what's going on?
I don't know, man. I wasn't
Oh, no, we got a wall on. That's what it is.
I did do that.
We do not want to use Knights of the Round against this enemy, because it will give the final boss way more HP.
I attacked the head a lot before he told me not to.
It's okay.
Oh, okay, okay, good.
Like a lot. Like 6 times.
Alright, so we're doing good so far. We're doing good.
So you can only hurt the head when the arms are down?
The arms are what caused me most of the damage.
Okay.
Okay, that was Magic Hammer. That just stole 100 HP from me.
Nice.
Which I did not show on screen how I did that, but, you know. We gave him an extra MP, an extra magic plus material, so his spells hurt more than normal. So this should be a 99. Nope, it's pretty close, though.
I do remember going back a bit in the comics here, the Gargoyles animated series.
That was on Fox Mornings, right?
Yeah, yeah. Four kids.
Four kids! Is it okay that I do his voice sometimes?
Yeah, sure. It's a good one.
I like Lou Vincent's voice.
Who doesn't?
That was bad!
Oh, he didn't die. You got the points.
That was his final, like, fuck you! I'm gonna attack you really hard! by the way, Matt has decorated the back, which you cannot see. He's showing PS4. This is my PS4.
Kind of sexy.
Yeah. Oh, man. We got an original NES back there. We can't see it, which is a damn shame.
I wish for my time.
Next time for the Resident Evil 7, we might create our own new YouTube channel. I'm thinking about that.
I'm going to try to talk about it.
Because right now it's okay. And I think it might be better for overall, because you might have to stick around and, you know, have the next. I can't even think right now, I'm so dry.
No, perfect time to go against Sephiroth.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
No save point for that whole thing.
I mean,
that's a lot.
Yeah, it's a long ways. But you could place that save point right there before we join parties.
Mm-hmm. We didn't do it.
Okay.
So we're in the gut of the planet. Planet gut. I think that's the
light.
This looks good.
A light.
One second.
Is this? Is this light holy?
Please tell me that's not an egg sac.
Thinks the Earth's egg sack. I think you're right, Patterson. Oh! Stevenson.
Oh, damn! Man! Stevenson!
What? 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 So everyone's together again?
Anybody could be saying that.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. He just Tyler Durdened into the frame for 1 second.
He Durdened us.
You've been Durdened.
You've been Durdened.
Sephiroth!
This is Sephiroth's power? My body! I can't control my body!
He's dancing.
The funny paper.
My front legs, my hind legs, my tail's about to rip off.
This is definitely not good. He's way out of our league.
I don't know if I can even, like, go on or something.
Porpoisey. Porpoisey, my only lines ever.
I know.
There. It's there.
Porpoisey. I give her some other lines.
It's terrible.
Holy. Holy.
Melody
is there.
Mike.
Holy materia is shining. Slum drunks. Prayer is shining!
Holy slum drunk!
Holy slum drunk!
That should be the name of the episode.
That is the name, dude.
It's not over yet. This isn't the end yet.
Okay, pick your party.
Okay, you got a sad porpoisey.
Time to fight.
Oh, God.
Just who's your strongesties?
Like I said earlier.
I wasn't listening earlier.
I mean, I span room breaks.
He's hurt.
Okay, let me see. That's all right. We can heal him. We're going to give you that and give your characters, right? Put them close to each other. Magic. This
that's
is
above Matt. Dude, all the time.
Dude, this is. This is
da,
scary.
Da da. Da da.
Da da.
Da da da.
Oh, it's
da,
only 100. Okay, we got like a lot of them, so we can definitely pump them up.
Yeah, we got that because we bought everything in the store.
Yeah, we'll take all of that. We're about to face the calamity from the skies, the fucking Sephiroth.
Yeah, it doesn't know where we are. Look, it's all
like,
question marks.
It's like, what? Where the hell are we?
Where nobody says where we're at?
Well, we don't want Porpoisey sad. Let's think about this a little bit before we do.
No, let's make them all sad. Let's all show them.
Let's
all
remember that we missed the sexy underwear or something like that. We have the sexy cologne.
What's that gonna do with anything?
Who knows? We have a snowboard. It's good.
We do have a snowboard.
There's like an 8-minute lag.
8-minute lag?
8-minute lag. Now, sometimes out there,
no way.
You can fast forward because, like, you lose it for a second and get behind.
There's no way.
I'm sorry if there's an 8-minute lag, Malibu Mike.
Oh, no. Just a moment. He gives us a second to look.
You didn't like what you had?
No, it was fine, but I want to make sure that I can switch that material.
It's named in a lag because it's such an epic part of the episode. It's slowing down the time as we know it. The fabric of time. Let's go, everyone. Yeah!
Oh!
We're not gonna lose!
Mike Malibu.
Slumdrunk is here. Everyone is here. Porpoisey is here with us. There's still a lot for us to do, and I'm not giving up. And stuff. I was frozen in time, but now I feel as though my time is finally beginning. Ah, Sephiroth, now it's your time to sleep for the ages.
I never heard that dialogue.
Slumdrunk's memories, our memories. We came to tell you our memories. Come, planet! Show us your answers! And Sephiroth, to the settling of everything!
All your voices.
I chose wisely, apparently.
Ah, correct, caveman us born.
Here it comes, here it is. Thanks for everybody for joining us. Think about the secrets of fire.
Be the best you're gonna get just by the song!
Oh boy.
Alright, so this is Sephiroth, just like we always know.
This is...
Well, he's sitting on top of a person. There's a little Sephiroth on top of that Genova. Hey, Genova, you got a little something.
Got a little something on you. Did I kill it already?
Right magic, D, dead.
Wow! Let me see here.
He's not as hard as some of the ultimate weapons we've already defeated.
Focus, prize.
We have not defeated any ultimate weapons.
What episode was I watching?
We beat Ultimate Weapon.
Yeah.
Which was not one of the Ultimate Weapons.
We fought the Under the Sea Emerald Weapon.
No, we didn't.
I thought we did.
No, we did not. We fought the one that flied around a bit.
Yeah, that's the Ultimate Weapon.
That's the Ultimate Weapon. The one under the sea is Emerald Weapon. The one in the sand below Golden Saucer is the...
And he killed us today.
Is the Ruby Weapon. Cool. Yes, we lost to him today. which I expected.
Focus power, Daniel Sand.
We'll do another episode where we do all that stuff.
Magic.
Focus power, Daniel.
Give us...
You're getting praise, Bryce. They say, focus, Bryce. Focus power, Daniel Sand. That's Karate Kid, if you didn't know.
Okay, I think here. Okay, magic hammer. No, I don't need that when I do that.
Yeah, you take a little magic. Why not?
Well, I have full magic.
Full...
Like I said, I'm going to try my best not to use the limit break spam. Quake 3.
Portion B just died.
I have played Final Fantasy my whole life. I should be able to do this.
I think so.
Yeah, I thought I was going to make us pick two teams. One of my characters and your characters. But I apparently did something that made just one.
I think the other team's coming in behind you, they said. So there'll be another team coming in.
So is this just one bite? Okay, I feel the arms.
This is it, the final battle. Don't let him heal himself.
I can't move. Satan slam. Shit.
Damn.
That doesn't sound good at all. That sounds real bad. Did he turn himself with?
Are you? Yeah.
What the fuck was that?
What do the sausages in the back mean?
Sausages? You know about these sausages back here?
Don't look at our sausages.
Breakfast.
Hey. Those are our sausages, dude.
I don't know. I don't know the sausages. Maybe it means in the back of the thing. On the screen.
Ultima. How about we try Ultima? How about that? Alright, just look, it's just a fucking boss. I have everybody equipped with a bunch of materia. I should be able to do this.
Hey, you're only convincing yourself. We all think you can do it.
No, I mean, I don't know if I've ever beaten this game legit. Chaos Saber. Alright, it's good that he's not elemental based, because that would be horrible. Because if, like, it was poison and he, like, absorbed poison.
Yeah.
And it's, like, it's a never-ending cycle of this. Oh, you're poisoning, you're healing it. You know, something like that.
I hear you.
So everybody's good health. Let's just attack this motherfucker.
Yeah,
let's
kill him.
Ooh, I'm gonna...
Knights of the Round!
Do we have that? Where is that? We do have it. It's equipped on Porpoise.
Porpoise is gonna do it. The Knights of the Round.
I think we're killing it without even trying.
Yeah, it kind of seems like it, but
Where's
we should at least keep trying.
Waffle representation in this game?
Waffle representation?
Yeah, yeah.
Am I just fucking dense?
I think we're being trolled now.
That's fine. I mean, hell.
We allow it.
Hell, Faujin gave up the fact that Ares died in, like, episode 3.
I think it was episode 1, actually.
What a dick.
Don't hate on one of our only fans.
Limit breakfast. Ha-ha.
Oh, limit, limit breakfast is good.
There's a great unlimited breakfast materia.
Not unlimited, no.
Dude, unlimited breakfast materia. I know I used to say big dick materia, but honestly, unlimited breakfast, I think, is better for a lifetime. Because eventually, I don't know, big dick. If you have a big dick and, like, you're old and you can't fuck
Hand
anybody,
platform.
What's the point? I don't know.
Hand platform.
I feel like we're doing pretty well.
I want to see Knights of the Round.
Well,
dude.
Dude.
I want to
okay,
see.
Okay, you've convinced me. Dude.
Dude.
It's like basketball. You guys, people
no
who like basketball, favorite movies. Let's do
it.
Favorite movies. Please list them in the comics below. In the comics and in the comments. Go ahead and do that. We will check back in the future.
Wish I wasn't listening to you at
all. I mean, this is going to be our most popular episode.
Well, it's the finale. People want to
oh,
see
it's
that.
Sinking like the fucking Titanic, dude. The Titanic.
Done.
Never let go.
Didn't have to use Knights of the Round.
Never let go. Jack.
I get it.
You get it?
Yeah. Someone has seen Knights of the Round.
Movie?
The what? Titanic movie?
Lord.
He's coming back.
You know what bothers me is that this
huh.
isn't centered.
I know who killed me.
Yeah.
This thing, it's not centered. We don't fully grasp this.
The camera's fuck? A little goofy. He's not dead, y'all.
Ruse.
It is a special song.
One winged angel. Big guard. Remember we learned it from the beach plugs. He's doing the same thing. Let's just mimic what he did. We're gonna protect ourselves from magic and physical attacks. The script isn't flipped. Cause I thought we were gonna have two teams. We have only one.
Yeah, I kind of thought the other team was gonna run out. This is cool.
I was gonna have a team. Okay, that hurt you pretty significantly. Okay.
You learned that enemy skill.
How? Oh, cause I had the enemy skill equipped.
Can you just run? F this.
Dude, I've been saying that for weeks. I'm like, I don't think so.
Alright, I've never done this before. This is it.
Oh, that music's getting epic, y'all. It's choir. Are we going to see Knights of the Round? Or
yes. Miss. I missed it.
You missed it.
No,
Sephiroth! Sephiroth!
He's got many wings, actually. He's a wingtipus. It's an octopus with wings or tentacles. A wingtipus.
Can't reach. Okay, he's become long range.
Knights.
Haste.
Knights.
Enemy skill. Okay, so you. He's fine. Tornado flare.
You're a frog!
Alright, that missed. Oh no, that is bad.
Now you're never gonna use lights of the round.
Oh shit.
Need a C-Cut-R.
Maiden's Kiss. Oh shit. He's doing his. This isn't good.
I do love me some KOTOR.
Oh no. Dude, watch. This gives credence to the fact that we are on an Earth-based planet because he sends a comet and it enters our Milky Way galaxy.
I wish his choir would appear in the clouds.
You're saying this is our universe.
This is his attack.
Oh, look, it's right through Pluto. You're right.
Yeah, going through Pluto. Which,
oh my god!
Which has been declassified and reclassified?
I don't know about that. But it destroyed it.
Saturn. I believe they've discovered more about the planet. I can't remember exactly what it said. Jupiter, the most frightening planet. They skipped Neptune. They skipped it. It was like, fuck
it. It wasn't in alignment.
Right? Neptune, right? Was that before Jupiter? Jupiter's like right next to Earth. Mars and then Earth.
I don't know.
No, that's definitely it.
Mars is the next closest.
They are skipping planets. I just want to use the Maiden's Kiss. So that's... What is that? What planet is that? How is this not going to kill us?
That's the sun.
Dude. You just destroyed Mercury, which is like beyond Gaia.
Oh my god.
See, there's the planet we're on, which is an Earth-like planet. Alright, so you're destroying the planet, but we're fine, because we have HP+.
They skipped Uranus too.
You got HP+, so you're going to be fine.
They're always skipping my Uranus.
Yeah. It's like a few planets. How is this gonna hurt us? I just want to use a fucking Maiden's Kiss.
No, it's gonna come right up to you, and you're gonna be fine.
38 damage. Cures frog, baby.
You can't see over your giant menu. How much did it take away?
What? What just happened? Did anything happen?
I can't see. I think it showed.
Did anything even fucking happen?
I think so. I think we cut him. We cut him real bad with a giant meteor.
Please don't die,
Are
please.
There any Iron Maiden materia? I skip Uranus too. Heyo.
Did we just die?
Heyo! Batoonch.
Maiden's Kiss. Okay. Got that. Cure 3. That's gonna be really good. Vincent died.
Yeah, you lost him forever.
Ultima, fuck you for killing him.
Vulcan, you're gaga then, for the grin.
Did I have life with him? Yes, life 2. Give that to Vincent. Ultima, we're gonna attack you because you're being an asshole and trying to kill us and the planet. Trying to suck up its fucking life force.
But trying to hurt the planet, Sephiroth.
I'm gonna dispel you because that's what I like to do when I have to. Alright, we revived him with full health.
Nice, right.
I'm confused.
Oh, Drake! It's a Drake! I will say, somebody's taking a long time to get their hair cut.
She's got some other errands to do. Omni Slasher, what you waiting for?
Can't take a drink every leg, right? Are you gonna take a drink?
Oh, shit, yeah, I'll drink. Here we go.
Sorry, I know we're in Vegas and we should have. Dude, Penelope is taking huge damage away from Sephiroth.
She's our best person. Oh! Sephiroth is, you know, it's a powerful dude. He's a wingtipus. He's one, not taking our
took,
shit.
It took one away.
First slice.
Only one.
Uh-huh.
Wow. Somersault, water kick, taking big damage away from him. I'm gonna fucking suplex him. Suplex Sephiroth. Dude, final heaven. Come on, hit me your Shrek. Final Heaven. Yeah, this is our ultimate our final limb break. I've never seen this before. It's just an ultimate punch.
It just punches the fuck out of it.
It's just like a Tyson just... BAM!
She kissed it first, like... BOOM!
Get it? Just kiss that.
Brains. Nothing but brains. I wish I could have seen how much Knights of the Round did to him.
Oh, we can do that still.
Then we did it already, didn't we?
No.
Oh, let's do it. Let's do Knights of the Round properly.
Okay, I'm at zero. Let me go ahead and...
Is this our only chance to ever use it?
Mm-hmm. Falcon Punch out.
Falcon Punch!
Falcon Punch!
Alright guys, thanks for joining us for the...
We're gonna turn Seth Roth into a frog right now.
That's not
frog song. Frog song.
That's never work.
That's it, Vincent. I am going to give you the frog.
Enjoy your life as a fucking frog.
Oh, it missed you. That's too bad.
Thanks for joining us, guys, as we defeat Final Fantasy VII. It's happening right now. You're joining us at the pivotal moment.
Is he gonna do this summon again? Oh, okay. Well, good thing we have the X3.
Oh, that was his summon who was doing to us before, I see.
Yeah, exactly. He's sending the... He's gonna do this all over again. Because the plants have regenerated. Oh, man. Look at that.
Jupiter hole.
Like, Jupiter is...
That's a nice Jupiter
hole. It's a gas giant. It's terrifying. It sucks in... Asteroids, like...
Where's the proof? Where's the proof of that, Bryce?
Dude.
Prove your astral bodies to me.
Jupiter is something to be feared. Maybe not in our lifetime. The sun is more to be feared. Because it's going to expand as time goes on. So, like, you know, I don't know if it's thousands. I don't think it's thousands. But that's going to happen. That will happen.
Yeah. I think it's slated.
Absolutely will happen.
I think it's slated for next week.
Damn it.
It's happening now.
Well, Resident Evil 7 just...
Off the slate.
I've been not thinking about what I'm doing.
Such a long one.
Alright, so we have haste. Porpoise is sad. Just like, you know, we gotta cure his sadness. Because that's like the point of the game, right? Isn't that like the whole goal of the game is to cure Porpoise's sadness? Scary
data. I guess we've yet to do it so far.
Right, give him a hyper. Oh no. Look at the life.
Yeah, you guys are low. You need to heal up, yep.
Imagine right. Falling into it. Terrifying.
Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no! We're gonna die! Dude, we're gonna die!
Maybe.
Dude, we're gonna die! Dude, we're gonna die! Oh shit on me.
You're okay. You survived.
Oh, what happened?
I don't know.
I heard
didn't
Jupiter
work.
Is just a bedroom and a giant baby.
This is so fucking stressful, dude.
I heard Jupiter is just a bedroom and a giant baby. That's
what?
Good.
Oh, we got reflect. Oh! Oh! Oh!
If you guys are just tuning in, this is Bryce's first time ever playing Final Fantasy.
Oh, dude, we're gonna die!
We're not gonna die! We're doing
we
great.
We can't cure ourselves!
Why not?
Okay, item. X potion.
Spam them limit breaks.
You're gonna kill him.
Spam them limit breaks is the recommendation from the,
No, no,
he's
no!
Not-
I don't have to fucking do that!
Shit on me, lol.
I don't have to do that. I don't have to use the fucking cheat code.
It's not a code.
You know.
Everybody's gonna die.
No.
Starting with you. You are our first.
Oh no. Oh no. Okay.
Look at the real worry in his face. You can see it. Bryce is really worried. I'm getting there and look at that worry face. Oh, he's fretting. His brows all furrowed.
Megalixir.
Elixir
we
first.
Need a Megalixir.
There it is. You got eight of them.
Okay, you killed him. That's fine. Okay, so... Vincent.
Porpoise needs remedy.
Yeah, Porpoise does need remedy, Jennifer. You're exactly right.
You're right. I'm not playing well.
Needs remedy.
He's doing this thing again.
0-1 anybody? Anybody?
About a space odyssey?
Shit, dude. Just go through this. Whatever. Destroy Pluto again.
Pluto is dead like Uranus.
Saturn is dead like Uranus.
Gonna make you famous.
Jupiter is dead like Greg Lou Gaines. Oh my gosh, Mars is dead. Gonna make you famous. Earth. Oh yeah. Crash Course. Seth Roth too. Oh,
Oversee Penelope and Vincent.
Ooh, here I am.
It's me. I'm here to say, I'm going to suck your blood in the vampire lair.
Oh my god, let me give me the cure 3, baby! Please, 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 no. This is fucking hard. This sucks, dude. I hate this. Oh my god, one? Dude! This sucks so bad! Oh my god, please no! Please no! Dude, I don't wanna die! Dude, I kill him?
You think you got it?
Oh my god!
I think we did it with one left.
Oh my god, dude!
Look at this face!
Oh my god, dude! Fuck you, Sephiroth, you son of a... I hate you! You're trying to destroy the planet of Gaia?
Broken heart. Emoji confounded face.
You wingapus motherfucker.
Look how these dolls are dissolving!
Oh my god.
You're broken. You did it.
God, Penelope and Vincent.
Cloud Lope missed out on some XP there. I mean, porpoisey. Good job, Bryce. I'm gonna be the first to say it. You did it, buddy. You fucking nailed it, dude.
How?
We just worked on him hard. We cut him, we poked him, we magicked him, we summoned it until he was dead.
We didn't use Knights of the Round.
We didn't get to use Knights of the Round. This is all we could do.
He was a frog for half the
night.
He was a fucking frog.
I felt so helpless. I felt so helpless.
Wait! What about Holy? What's gonna happen to the planet?
That, I don't know. Isn't the rest of it up to the planet?
You're right.
We've done all that we could do. We literally saved it dozens of times from monsters. All right, everyone. We did our best. Only one of us died, and that's it. Let's go home proud. You don't have a home.
She's not good.
No, it was a slum drunk who died. Boink, boink.
I'm going home.
That's a pretty, what happened? I feel it. What? Is still here. Still!
Every time he has a nervous breakdown.
Which is every episode.
We drink.
Still!
This is the final taste. This is the final taste.
MOG trophy. MOG military medal. MOG sports medal.
He's laughing. Like Hojo.
Whoa! He just does some fucking moves.
Porpoisey! We should have drank every time we said porpoisey, and we would never have made it through this series.
We would have died.
Okay, guys, it's not gonna show you the scene. It's gonna censor us.
I'm sorry.
But it's the secret to life. It's telling us the secrets of all the universe.
Well, let's get close, since this is our last chance with them, okay? This is Matt over here.
Hello. So,
Oh, who am I?
This is Bryce also. I'm watching the ending. I know they can't see it.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I've seen it once.
He's being sucked to a different place. Cloud has been sucked through a dimension.
That's the unfortunate circumstance of broadcasting via PS4. And we will work towards getting an ability to stream 64 games, PS1, you know, all the different systems.
I'd like to do some weird games.
Yeah, I would love to go back in history.
Yeah, they cut out the video, guys. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. We're getting
They don't let us broadcast the super secret image. So Cloud is now sucking through the dimensional portal, thrusting at Sephiroth, and now they're standing here back to back to battle. I'm sorry, the opposite of back to back, front to front. And just Cloud and Porpoisey versus Sephiroth. Here you go. My color commentary has never been more important. They face off. Porpoisey starts at the limit break. He selects Omni Slash. Sephiroth comes in with the first swing, 5,700 damage. Porpoisey's almost dead already.
He's down to 186 hit points. Sephiroth kneels in defeat.
We each slash each other but once.
It said we're not on air, right?
Just okay. Our audio. I think our audio's still out there,
good.
Y'all.
Okay. Good.
Sephiroth blew up into a pink ball of nothing with his face bloodied.
Cloud, with a scar on his face from the battle ensued. The life stream ensues him.
Encircles him.
Encircles him. That's a better word for it.
He looks in awe as green bits of vapor and ether wisp around him so elegantly, like a unicorn taking a dump.
That's... I'm making a boner.
Life stream, Cloud says, as he looks up in a full motion video. He looks right at the camera, extending his hand up into the beaming light of the life stream. A hand reaches through the light. Who could it be? Somebody is pulling Cloud back into reality. He reaches for the hand. Oh my God, it's Tifa.
Penelope.
It's Penelope.
If you will. He's gonna fall into the life stream. It's he's all reaching for her. She falls.
He grabs her.
He runs for her and grabs upon the edge of the cliff and dangles with Penelope in her arms. Penelope says, I understand what...
An answer from the planet. The promised land. He says, dangling from the cliff, pulling himself with one hand. I think I can meet her there. Yeah, let's go meet her, says Penelope, as Cloud, one arm, pulls them both up off the edge of the cliff. It's like that Stallone movie, Cliffhanger. Still pulling themselves off the cliff, still wounded and tired, Cloud says, where is everyone? They're all there. It's cool. They're all just kind of hanging around. Barrett says, but now what are we going to do? Snoop Lion says, holy should do something. It's going too fast. I didn't read it. There's some dialogue. Everyone's getting a one-liner. Classic one-liner that you guys will never know. Sid looks up and a cigarette falls out of his mouth. Oh my God, the whole hole they're in is collapsing. No, scratch that! The Highlander. Is that the name of our boat? Our airship?
The Highland.
The Highland. Highland. Is crashing Highland. Through. Down into the pit where they all hang. Now external shot of the exterior shot of the Northern Cavern. Emitting large blue goo. I don't know if they can see this still or not. I don't know if you guys are bad. It looks like you're not.
They can't. Unfortunately, PS4 will not allow us to show this.
So the crater spits our ship out. It gets destroyed. Oh my God, our ship. It's ruined forever. Every piece is flying off of it.
Oh, I'm hanging on for dear life.
He said, shit.
I'm reaching for the emergency. Pull. I'm pulling it.
It blows up, crashing. It catches air and flies away right before hitting the ground. They're not dead. Cut to, looks like, Nibelheim?
As always.
As always, cut to Nibelheim.
Cut to Nibelheim. It's a little girl.
It's Marlene.
The flower girl. She opens the windows to reveal a red,
it's meteor!
Much like Majora's Mask, the planet is coming very close to crashing against Midgar and the planet as a whole.
So we've stopped Sephiroth, but we have not stopped Meteor.
Small tornadoes have overtaken Midgar, and they're swallowing up every bit of Midgar and destroying the Shinra Tower and the slums below.
And Barret's ultimate weapon inside that we never got.
Got that one.
Sorry, guys.
We were fighting the Turks, which are now dead. I would say the Turks are dead.
Turks are there in Midgar. I think everybody in Midgar's dead.
Yeah, that was not great.
But Marlene is not in Midgar. She's safe.
It was like... Oh, okay.
Oh, wait. Oh, no. A big blue light is coming in.
What? Something is defending Midgar. The small girl is wincing her eyes in the sight of this protection.
It's the life stream.
It's something beyond is protecting the planet.
From Meteor. Meteors.
It's perhaps a former party member whose prayers are answering our call to please protect the planet.
But it's not working. Meteor is forcing through anyway.
Yes, they're struggling between. Streamer Tower is being destroyed. The High Wind is
flying overhead.
Yeah.
As Cloud and our party watches on.
Well, you know? This looks like, damn, wait a minute. What's going to happen to Midgar? Marlene is there. That can't happen.
All right, everyone, take refuge in the slums. But the way things are now. Dot, dot, dot.
It's too late for Holy. Meteor is broaching the planet. Holy is having the opposite effect. Forget Midgar. We gotta worry about the planet. Oh, God, I'm fucking high.
Snoop Lion,
baby. Red 13. Nanaki.
This is all full motion video at the end. You guys are really missing out.
This is unfortunate. What's that?
Little materia down there. Or something. Nope, it's life force.
If we want to get the master material, we gotta go back.
So the meteor is red. The planet was blue. This is a green color.
I mean, you can't see this, so it's really just our descriptions. But ultimately, it comes down to us thanking you so much for being here, for Bryce and Matt play that. We're drinking a couple bottles of booze for sure. He drinks wine. I drink shots generally. And it's just been so much fun, you know? Otherwise, I'd just be playing it by myself, without Matt even, probably. He might join in a couple times, but this has been so much fun. Like, just playing with you guys, and it's really been cool. I've always wanted to do a Let's Play, and to do it with one of my best friends of all time.
Oh, well, thank you. I feel the same way.
That's really cool.
I couldn't have done this without Bryce. Wouldn't have done this without Bryce. Glad to play this game again with a lot of you guys. If you haven't yet, follow us, subscribe. We're going to come back with Resident Evil 7 after just a short hiatus of a week or so. And it's going to be a whole different game.
I mean, next Saturday, perhaps?
Perhaps.
Same time?
Let's not go hard on it, but I think Saturday is a good day for us.
I mean,
once a week will be enough for this next game.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't mind doing more than that. I mean,
I think we're really...
The live stream is taking over the planet and restoring the strength of the planet. And warding off Meteor, which is good because Meteor is bad.
Yeah, Holy is being joined by the live stream.
Yeah, it's kind of a convoluted story for sure. I need to be listening to this. Sorry.
Speech, as he said, and like Brian said, thanks. And
I mean, I don't want to leave anybody out, but Drew, Kevin, Logan.
Hey, Brian, everybody here tonight,
Melanie,
CM,
Jennifer, Miranda, Sylvie. Jennifer Silver for sure. She was a big proponent of the Penelope storyline.
Steven.
God, I'm so excited for the next playthrough.
Steven was always good to have. I think he shared a lot of our stuff too. Devin's out there.
And Steven, who is a local here in Las Vegas, he promotes a lot of local improv shows. And he's also promoted some of our live streams, which is very appreciated. We can't thank you enough for just being someone who can stand up for us and just give us a chance, you know? We're just starting out, and we're new, but, you know, we're having a lot of fun playing games with you guys who remember the good old days. And also the new old days.
Because the next game is not old. It just came out a few months ago. So... Sorry,
this is crazy.
Comments are talking to us.
I'm all right. So glad.
We did it.
What
we did
say?
It without you guys.
Saying?
They say, take, Devin says, well played. He'll take our word on the special ending. Jennifer says it's been fun. Fab says he's pumped for Resident Evil 7 since he's currently playing it. Courtney says A+. Favorite moment, Kevin wants to know. Favorite moment of the series?
Well, I mean, immediately, I would say that when Ultimate Weapon came to just, I think it was the last episode.
He flew over our heads?
Yeah, it's like, oh my god!
We're both all the same. Like, get that motherfucker!
Yeah, exactly. And I would say, I mean, our most viewed episode was when we got to cast Casa de's soul. Play some Zeppelin. I've listened to a lot of Metallica recently, and I will say that's pretty good. It's been a lot of fun to listen to that.
All right.
I know they had a Grammy mishap.
I don't know.
Lady Gaga played with them.
Yeah.
And James Hetfield, the lead singer, his mic was not working. So if you look up James Hetfield, Metallica, Lady Gaga, I'm sure you'll find it.
That's my number one circuit.
The Grammys are just known for fucking shit up. It's like, sure, Beyonce didn't win.
What are you talking about? This?
No, Beyonce didn't win. Adele won.
Yeah.
But it's like, they make it a racial thing, which it's not a racial thing. It's Adele wrote all of her songs for her album. That's a fact. She wrote all of the songs. Beyonce didn't write them, which I mean, from what I understand, she may have written a couple of them, but not all of them. Adele wrote all of her songs, and she won Album of the Year. She wrote them, she performed them, she went out on tour with these songs, and, you know...
We love you, Adele.
Beyonce is great, and she preferred...
I love Queen Bee.
She provides Queen Bee. Queen Beyonce. Adele, today. I mean... Adele is great. I mean, I'm not a huge pop fan. I'm a punk fan. Fanned.
You're a fanned punk. Someone fans you.
Yeah, I mean, I love punks, like late 90s punk. That's what I'm into. You know?
I know. I do know.
Matt knows this.
All right.
He's saying X-Hack. Yeah, I should have. It's like, just because Beyonce doesn't win a Grammy, it's just like an open... If an open mic night performer performs at a show where an open mic night performer has a lot of friends and family from the local area to vote for him or her, they will win that local competition over, you know, someone touring, because that's just how they do it. If you have more supporters, you will win a local competition. It's just the way it goes. Like, there's a local guy.
I think the Grammys are racist.
Ryan Barasa, who's very funny, and he has lots of posts on Facebook, and he has lots of likes on Facebook. And locally, I think he's one of the funniest people in town that I've encountered. And sure, this is just the ending credits of a Final Fantasy VII game. But locally, Las Vegas, this is becoming an esports hub. And we're going to incorporate fighting games into our Let's Plays. You know, energies.
Maybe some competitions.
Energies. I mean, I'm sure I'll be terrible. But like Def Jam Fight for New York or WWF No Mercy, I feel very confident with my skills as Taka Michinoku. Taka Michinoku, my friends.
Can I be the Green Hurricane?
Green Hurricane? Hurricane Helms, I think is what you're referring to. I watch wrestling regularly, so if you want to chat with me about wrestling, I'm all about it. At Bryce Versa, go ahead and talk to me about wrestling, because I love talking wrestling with you guys. And at Matt Smith...
No, actual Matt Smith.
Actual Matt Smith. Actual Matt Smith.
And we can talk about ARK. We have a private server, at least for the rest of the month. If we can get some people on, maybe we'll keep it going. But if you play ARK, hit me up. If you like to wrestle, hit Bryce up. Thank you for being the best fans in the world. Thank you for listening to us play, drink, swear, and defeat the fuck out of Final Fantasy VII.
We did it, dude. Yeah. Oh, my God.
We all did it together, including you guys.
It's 10:16 right now. I'm, like, promoting myself, like... Bryce and Matt, which is the most important, and then Bryce Versa and actual Matt Smith are secondary to that. But Bryce and Matt, we hope to play more games with you in the future.
Follow us so that you can see when we're going to play again. We're going to do Resident Evil 7. Bryce and Matt play that probably starting next week. Hit us up, guys. Follow us, and we will catch you on the webs.
GeoCities/TheMundyFeeling.
GeoCities/TheMundyFeeling. What's that?
Angel Fire.
Angel Fire. All right.
Yeah, we are definitely a retro team, but we are definitely so interested in Final Fantasy VII, Resident Evil 7, which is our next playthrough. We're going to have the camera, not VR, because we're too scared and poor. To do the PS4 VR. But 500 years later, it says...
Hold on. There's a post-credits in here.
Yeah, there's a lot of credits, which, I mean, I don't want to discredit any of the people that worked on this game, because this is so much fun.
500 years later?
Yeah, and all the people that worked on this game, please look up online the Final Fantasy VII ending, and you will see all the people that worked on this game... All the people that tried to make this CG animation, which was brand new on the scene, 97.
In this final scene, 500 years later, Red 13 is running across the planet with two little baby Red 13s in tow.
Yeah. Red 13 was the name Hojo gave to them, which Hojo is enemy. He's Nanaki.
Nanaki.
Not a stoop lion. You know, he's not a pot-smoking lion. He's
the probably the badass creature in the game.
And which is,
look at know, it. We're seeing it's all always, taken over by the Earth.
Yeah, we criticized Nanaki for not having a fulfilling storyline, but at the end, he's looking over a cliff over Midgar, which is overrun by greenery,
plant life, and more. So the Mako is returned to the Earth. The Earth has taken over man, and now Nanaki has a place to be. That was a good ending. I'm gonna clap. Well, clap for Final Fantasy VII. I'm glad we stalled and you drunkenly chuckled the Grammys for 5 minutes so we could see the secret scene. I didn't know it was coming.
Oh, that was so awesome. Just Naki and his little cublings looking over Midgar, just overrun by greenery, which a lot of people lost their lives. And we're back to live broadcast, and we're getting the original theme. This is how we started. Episode 1. Hopefully, we have learned a lot about live streaming broadcast. Matt and Bryce play that. Bryce Almost. And Matt, whatever.
some dudes some play dudes. Something.
So it's so awesome. And like, I don't want to make it hyperbole.
I love green.
But I love green. Is that what he said?
Knox said, "No, hey, thank you for joining." We just beat this game, if you're just joining in, perfect time to watch us say, we love you guys, we love Final Fantasy, and we're gonna catch you next week when we start playing a different game altogether.
Final Fantasy, Resident Evil 7. Resident Evil 7. You know, I just wanna mention my big inspiration as far as Let's Plays go. I wanna say the Gang Grumps are great. They are so funny. It's so natural. I relate with them so much. And I hope that we can become a part of the Let's Play universe, you know? And we're just playing video games, old school video games, new video games like Resident Evil 7.
So would it be bad for our thing right now if I called out Game Grumps and we started a feud? I'm going to start a Twitter feud.
No,
with them.
I don't want to start a feud.
Game Grumps, this is to you. Okay.
They're so good.
I've heard a couple things. They are super good.
Super best friends. They've lost a few members, but I mean, I love their play. They're a very big Resident Evil team. Mm.
So they're going to watch us play the next one then.
Oh, they're so good.
We'll see you there, Game Grumps.
And super best friends. They lost Liam, and I think they lost another.
They didn't die.
No, they didn't die.
Okay.
But, you know, it's a lot of stress. I mean, we're early on in our Let's Play lives. You know, this is our first game.
You're saying I'm not an old soul?
I mean, you're an old soul.
Fuck you. Oh, okay, good.
You're an old soul.
I was going to turn on you.
But, I mean, we just want to play these old games that make us feel young again. And Resident Evil 7 makes us feel scared again.
And I'm going to be scared again.
Yeah, it's going to be scared to keep your life, you know.
Well, let's find out next week. That's all
exactly.
We can do.
I mean, next Saturday, we're going to start Final Fantasy VII.
No.
What?
Resident Evil 7. But oh yeah, next week, tune in and we start Final Fantasy VII all over again. Now you can see our backlog episodes on the YouTubes and all that.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what? We get more people just bullshitting with a blank screen than we got the whole time playing. Next week, we play nothing, and we just talk about other games we played. And we're going to get the most viewers ever had. Hey, subscribe, follow us on Facebook. Bryce, let's put a motherfucking ribbon on this. Get out of here.
Okay, well, my name is Bryce. This over here is Matt with one T.
Singular.
Don't forget that. That's important. We got a lot of things going on right now. Let's plays, sure. Things other than that? Maybe.
Maybe Bryce and I are working on a script. Maybe Bryce and I are working on something else.
This guy does a lot of writing. This guy does a lot of artwork. Combined, who knows? Something from many years ago could revive itself.
Oh, he's
revived too.
Hint, hint. Secrets.
Basically, we love you guys. This has been so much fun. We beat the game. I really was worried about it.
We didn't die.
Honestly, this is one of the easiest Final Fantasy games.
He's easier than, yeah.
But, you know, we did it anyway. We were drunk as fuck. So that's that is something. And in the future, look out for the Final Fantasy VII Ultimate Weapons.
Yeah. We're not done with the whole game completely. We might do a couple little specials here, do the Ultimate Weapons, anything we may have missed.
Neither of us have ever beaten these Ultimate Weapons. Mm-mm. And it'd be awesome to do so. So we are going to do that.
I think we do an end of the year episode where we go back and do a little bit from each game we played all year long. So we go back and do the Final Fantasy, go back and do something with Resident Evil, and then something, you know, whatever else the year holds for us.
Okay.
Year in review.
It's going to be scary as hell because we do not know much about this game.
Oh, and I drink so much liquor, it's going to be very.
I'm glad I don't have to play it. Because it's so fucking scary.
We're going to find out soon.
But thank you, Kevin.
All the people we said earlier.
This is a painful thing to...
We plugged everybody. We said it all. I think we're good.
Drew, Logan,
and Kevin, and Devin, and we said them all.
Drew, Logan.
We said it. Let's let these motherfuckers go. I like them. We love them. We want some more of them.
Special movie?
Specifically next week. I'm sure we
can
share
that. What does that mean? That means something. Special movie?
Okay.
For those of you who stayed around, let's look at this.
It's not, I don't know if it'll broadcast out or not, I guess.
Long ago, we looked upon a foreboding sky.
Isn't this for afferent children?
This is for, star. Exactly right. We watched this, in fact. It is for afferent
eternal in our hearts.
Which we can't show on our Let's Play.
No, this is the Let's Play for...
Oh, this is the remake.
This is the remake.
Final Fantasy VII remake.
Which surely we will do.
Silence.
I mean, we're just a little young and still tight here.
Fond we're going to do it when it's 15 years old.
We knew those encountered were not forgotten.
All right. I'm done. Matty S.
That Sunday, we would see them.
Walk away from the podcast.
You're going to say for the Bonus 7 remake?
Wishful. No, I thought I'd seen that thing 100 times.
Come on, let's see ya. Tetsura. I missed the last name.
But after the long calm, there are now the beginnings of a stir.
A little better.
The reunion at hand may bring joy. It may bring fear. But let us embrace whatever it brings. For they are coming back.
Oh, I've got my wicked
at last,
weird arm.
The promise has been made.
Dude, this is gonna be so much fun. I will play the fuck out of this game.
Dude, oh, yeah, dude.
The remake of Final Fantasy VII?
They're just calling it a remake. That's crazy.
Yeah.
But no, we can't do any voice acting, because they're going to have people do that.
Yeah, that's very true.
All right, guys. Thanks for joining us on the finale of this season of Bryce and Matt Play That Final Fantasy VII. We'll see you next Saturday. Anything else you want to add?
Thank you so very much for joining us, and we'll see you next Saturday for Resident Evil 7.
I know, we're gonna have a hard time saying that.
Yeah.
Alright guys, thank you. Hashtag my Midgar.
My Midgar. Oh man, love you guys so much. Let's go ahead and end this broadcast.